The following is a production of Hometown and Home Country Radio Sports.
We've never seen a team like this before, ladies and gentlemen. After all this time, Bishop Garrigan is still golden. Bishop Garrigan has finally slain the Newell Fonda Dragon. Your Golden Bears are state champions for the second year in a row.
This place is packed, and it is going to be rocking in here tonight. Crooks taps it backwards, and we are underway. Buckle your seatbelts, everyone. In the lane, Crooks, center of the paint. Oh, a nice spin move, and she lays it in.
Oh, with her left hand, she claps her hands and says, let's go. You got to feed Audie this last 2 minutes.
Three-pointer is blocked at the buzzer, and that's it. After coming so close the past 2 years, Bishop Garrigan has finally won it all.
Video streaming on the Algona Radio YouTube channel is brought to you by Kemna Auto Center. It's not just about the car, it's about the care. Algona Municipal Utilities, community owned for community benefit. Bauer Plumbing and Heating of Emmitsburg and Algona. Iowa State Bank, helping people succeed. Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident. PMC Advantage Insurance, having the advantage makes all the difference. Now, here's Sports Director Tyler Lance.
Two teams that are undefeated in top of Iowa West play battle tonight as the 2-1 Lake Mills Bulldogs right now are 2-0 in conference play. Take on the 3-0 Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. Good evening, everyone. Tyler Lance with you on Hometown Radio, KLGA Algona, and at the Algona Radio YouTube channel. And an interesting matchup tonight. It's a new-look Lake Mills team, one that has some experienced faces on the roster, but also some inexperienced faces and a new injection of talent coming into the Bishop Garrigan High School Gymnasium tonight to take on a new-look Golden Bear team as well. On the Lake Mills side of things, of course, they return first team all-conference star Taylor Vonick, who averaged 14 points per game last season and is now in her senior season, but she's joined by a freshman complement, Cora Sauer, who so far has scored 50 points through three games and is shooting 42% for the field and 8 of 19 on three-pointers. Those two make a 1-2 punch in the backcourt of Lake Mills, and they provide a ton of challenges for Bishop Garrigan tonight. Meanwhile, the Golden Bears squeaked by this past Saturday, defeating Western Christian 67-62, staving off a late rally in a non-conference matchup, and the Golden Bears right now are 1-0 in top of Iowa West play, look for their 58th straight top of Iowa West win and 44th straight home win. That is what the Golden Bears will be going for tonight. We will step aside for a quick timeout here from both head coaches ahead of tonight's game. Coach Beth Van Ruckel of the Lake Mills Bulldogs and Coach Brandon Schwab of the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears coming up next on KLGA and the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
High school basketball coming up on Hometown Radio KLGA tonight as the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears host the Lake Mills Bulldogs. And right now we check in with Bishop Garrigan head coach Brandon Schwab. Coach, obviously a great start for the team so far, 3-0 on the season, as this past Saturday you guys hit the road for the first time this year and held off a late rally to defeat Western Christian 67-62. Just take me through a few key moments in that ballgame, what you felt were a few keys to defeating Western Christian this Saturday.
Well, I thought we were able to hold them from getting to the paint a lot. They were a team coming in that didn't shoot the ball great from the perimeter, so our goal was try to keep them out of the paint, and it kind of bit us with them hitting 8 threes on us. So they shot the ball extremely well, and that's kudos to them. And I thought offensively we shared the ball very well. They really focused on trying to contain Sasha, and we had Emmy and Graceland really step up offensively for us with Abby Capacious, and Sasha was still able to get in double digits. So, 4 girls in double digits makes us really tough to defend, because you're not going to be able to just key on one girl on our team. We have multiple scorers, and I thought we showed that on Saturday.
And, Coach, I think you referenced a key point there, because for Bishop Garrigan, winning differently on a night-to-night basis is going to be a key. The first couple games, you guys hit a ton of three-pointers. On Saturday, it wasn't quite as much of the threes, but like you said, you kind of spread the scoring around a little bit and won in a different way. So, just speak a little bit on this new-look lineup this year, finding different ways to win throughout the course of the season.
Yeah, you know, we knew coming in, and we've said this from day one, that, you know, we've got to share the ball, and there's going to be probably a different leading scorer every time we play. And we've got to find what gives us the best matchup against the other team. And, you know, what the defense is always given something. They're going to try to take something away from you, and you've got to answer by finding a different way to score, a different person to score. So, you know, we were really able to mix up our offenses and really execute in some different ways than we have this season, which was good. You know, I mean, the way they were playing us in the post, we were able to work the ball through the post a lot and, you know, get the ball to Graceland. And, you know, we were getting inside out shots that were good. So it was just I thought a pretty balanced game against a very athletic team. We won't see that type of athleticism and length probably all of the rest of the season. You know, when they go 2 6-footers starting in the lineup with a 5'10 guard and then bring 2 5'10 girls off the bench, that it's a hard matchup problem. We're not the tallest team. We've got some good team speed, but you know, that length gave us some problems, but we're able to battle through it.
And Coach, Top of Iowa West play resumes tonight as you guys host Lake Mills. And a little bit of a different look for the Lake Mills team in their starting lineup. They have a freshman starting right now who's been really impressive so far, of course, Sauer. What have you seen from that Lake Mills freshman and some of the challenges that she might present tonight?
Yeah, Coach, she's an outstanding player. I mean, I've watched every one of her games on film so far, and she really demands the ball. She's very athletic. She puts a lot of pressure on your defense, and it's a great compliment to Taylor Vonick. I mean, this is the best guard Taylor's had in her 4-year career at Lake Mills, of having this 1-2 punch with Sauer is big for their team. I mean, Lake Mills is very much improved. They're going to bring some length, and with two really good guards, with Vonick and Sauer on the floor, they definitely cause some matchup problems for us.
Talking right now with Bishop Garrigan head coach Brandon Schwab. And Coach, I think the past couple of years it would have been a little easier for Lake Mills team just to cue in on Vonick and let other things be what they may, but like you said, they kind of have a 1-2 punch right now in their guard court. So how do you approach that defensively when you have Vonick and Sauer really kind of spreading the scoring around?
Well, you know, we're gonna match our two best, what I feel our two best defenders on. Obviously, we still got to focus on Vonick. I mean, she's a all-conference player and a 4-year starter for him. And, you know, we're gonna put pressure on her. You know, we're gonna definitely key on those girls, and it'll be a host of different players gonna guard them. They don't sub out a lot. We're gonna try to keep a fresher girl on them, and you know, obviously starting with an Abby Capacious on Sauer is a good matchup. Abby's a great defender, and we're going to see if, you know, our senior can kind of contain her a little bit, at least early in the game. But it's going to be a team matchup. We're not going to just put one girl on her and say it's your only job to worry about that. You know, it's a team game, and our team defense and our team defensive game plan has got to be focused on those two players. But you know, we're going to need each other to help each other out, because they like to put a lot of pressure on dribble penetration to the middle of your defense. And they're a good job of dishing off and hitting that mid-range floater, and can extend out to three. So, yeah, it causes us some problems, and we're going to definitely have to mix it up on them tonight.
Coach, as we wrap up, what do you feel is the biggest key for a Golden Bear victory?
Well, we've got to, again, get the game to our pace. You know, we've got to be able to get it to a back and forth pace and have it in a full court game. We don't want to slow it down. We don't want to go half court to half court against really anybody. That's not what our makeup is of this year's team. And you know, we're just hoping them to get the pace of the game the way we want it, and able to get them one and done, and you know, just be able to out execute them.
Coach, best of luck in tonight's game, and thank you for the time today.
All right, thanks.
That is Bishop Garrigan Golden Bear head coach Brandon Schwab on the pregame show. We will step aside for a timeout and get you closer to tip-off coming up next on KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube stream. And we get ready for high school basketball action right now on Hometown Radio KLGA, as it'll be the Lake Mills Bulldogs against the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. And right now we check in with Lake Mills head coach Beth Van Rokel. Coach, first of all, we appreciate your time today getting ready for tonight's game. Can you start us off with just a quick recap of the first three games of the season, as far as what some of your big takeaways were coming out of those?
Basically just getting experience. So the first three games, lost the first one, but got able to full way on the second two and get the wins, which is huge. We have a lot of the experienced players that just haven't had a lot of varsity time in the past. So returning our point guard, which is amazing, and then that's about it. A lot of people don't have much experience. So just getting these girls some court time, getting experience, getting through the nerves, learning the pace, getting some real defense from other people, and that's not just us, has been a huge huge thing this week and the last week and a half, getting these games in. And then being able to still pull out the victories on a couple of those is really important and very proud of them. So kind of our focus is getting comfortable, trying to now, you know, fine-tune things, reduce turnovers, that kind of stuff, increase our, you know, percentages. Field goal percentage is a big thing as well now as we move forward.
And coach, so far this season, freshman Cora Sowers played great and really added another score next to Taylor Vonick. When did you know you had this kind of player coming in of Sauer?
Last year. I mean, honestly, we've known about her for a long time. I know her family well. Obviously, it's Lake Mel, so we're a small community, and she was one of my managers last year. Her and the friends are out for basketball as well. So I've known her potential. I've seen her work ethic. I've seen her in the gym. I've seen her shooting all the time, all year long. Honestly, though, I didn't really know she would do this well right off the bat. Like, she's playing like a veteran player right now. I mean, she's making mistakes here and there, but every player does that. And so she's just playing insane. I didn't know her defense would be as good as it is. She played amazing defense against Addie Lamb that first half, especially against Belmont. You know, held her scoreless, face guard her everywhere. Like, I'm super impressed. And she's just the nicest, kindest girl. And doesn't have a mean bone in her body, but, man, she loves basketball. So that's been a huge, huge bonus. I knew she was good, but she's been even better than I thought and been a huge help for Taylor. Obviously, you know, we're missing Bryn Rognes. She would have been a returning starter, you know, three-year starter for us, and she had an ACL injury this summer. Hopefully get her back here soon. So having Cora come up and step up like she is with that scoring has been really important to take some of the pressure off Taylor and let Taylor do her thing and get open a little more, and now Cora can do a lot of stuff. She's a little taller, which is helpful as well as for a guard, so that's good.
No doubt about it. And, Coach, so far this season, you're 2-0 on the top of Iowa West, game number 3 in the conference coming up tonight, and, of course, the conference looking a little more wide open this year, so what do you need to see from your girls this season to really put your name into the conversation for contending for that top of Iowa West race?
I mean, we got to take every game. We got to focus on every game. We got to take every game important, no matter who it is. And I know we lost to some teams last year we shouldn't have. We played really tough and beat some teams we probably shouldn't have last year. So we have the potential, and it is wide open. I mean, anybody can have a rough game. I've seen a lot of rough games. I've seen a lot of good games from all around the area this year. And, you know, if you're a shooting team and you have an off night, it gives an opening for someone else. And if you're a defensive team, it means you're always in the running unless you make some baskets too. So I just going each game, going in, I mean, obviously, yes, this year it is more open. There's some opportunities for the, you know, being a top three or whatever in the conference for a lot of different teams. People are going for it, so we got to take one game at a time. We got to finish games. Last year we lost so many games near the end. I didn't finish games. Record's been a lot different. You know, at least 5-6 games could have turned different at the end. So, you know, girls coming in, being confident, playing with confidence, and just going after it and not, you know, cowering to anybody, but just being confident. And if they make a mistake, shake it off. Go after it, and we got to finish shots. And know our matchups, know our defense, know our plan, and if they can figure out what they're doing and guard the people they need to guard at the right spots. I think they'll make a big difference as in each game and as the season goes on. And I think a lot of people are going to see some different things this year between, you know, wins and losses and all different types of teams. So it should be an interesting season. Hopefully we can all make it interesting and just play some really good basketball.
Talking right now with Lake Mills head coach Beth Van Rokel. Coach, another big top of Iowa West matchup tonight as you guys visit Bishop Garrigan. What stands out to you about the Golden Bears?
The shooting range and shooting percentage. Obviously, they have some amazing sharp shooters. They're really young. We saw a little bit last year, and obviously they're shooting really deep, and they're very accurate. So that's the big thing tonight. You know, they got a new girl came in, too, and at the post, and so focusing and knowing what she can do. And then, you know, Capacious is just a solid, very solid, smart ball player who kind of, I call her kind of like the captain out there. She runs the show, but integral part of that. So just taking control of that and playing good defense on her too, and we just gotta control where we want them to shoot, and we gotta know who we're matching up with and who we're guarding, and we gotta get in the right spots and make them do things they don't want to do and make them uncomfortable. It's kind of the goal, and then play our game and try to make shots that we know we can make too, and then just make it a battle. I hope it's a battle. I hope we can take it to them and get a chance at the end to see if we have a chance we could win. It's been a long, long time since we beat them, obviously, and so just have a chance would be nice and go after it and see what we can do.
Coach, as we wrap up for today, what do you feel the biggest key for a Lake Mills victory is?
Really knowing who we're guarding and getting on them in the right spots that we need to get on them. And secondly, on offense, we have to finish shots, and we got to make the shots that we're just missing sometimes right now. We got to finish. We have an easy bucket inside. We got to finish our floaters that are going in, driving to the lane. So if we can and take care of the ball. So if we can take care of the ball, finish our shots, and play defense like I know we can. We had a great defensive game the other night. We got to know who we're guarding, and we got to guard them the way we're supposed to guard them. And if we do that, then we have a good chance. I think we can go after it and give them a ball game. So.
Well, Coach, we appreciate your time today and wish you best of luck in tonight's game.
Thank you.
Lake Mills head coach Beth Van Rokel wrapping up here on Hometown Radio KLGA. We'll step aside for a quick timeout. Tip-off is coming your way at 6:15 here on KLGA 92.7 and at the Algona Radio YouTube stream. It's time to meet the starting lineup for the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears.
Grayson Eastman, freshman, number 14. Emmy Bartolo, sophomore, number 10.
Cross-court feed over to Bartolo. Catches, fires, rattles in a three-pointer.
Tayshia Aulish, sophomore, number 24.
Tayshia hangs and passes to left wing. Aulish three-try, and she squished it again. Let's Tayshia Aulish shoot it.
Zoe Montag, junior, number 22.
Garrigan to the steal. Here comes the transition. A sidestep by Montag in the lay-in. Zoe Montag is going crazy right now, and Garrigan's up 81-38.
Abby Capacious, senior, number 21.
Finds Capacious inside, underneath the bucket, high off the glass. She put it down, and she got fouled. Tip-off of your game is coming up next on Hometown and Home Country Radio. The Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears and the Lake Mills Bulldogs. Lake Mills starting lineup is Taylor Vonick, Cora Sauer, Ella Reddig, Bailey Dagstead, and Ava Moen as Bishop Garrigan wins the opening tap. And we are underway from Bishop Garrigan High School. Golden Bears head left to right on the radio dial. An early post touch by Eastman. One dribble, puts up the layup and missed it. And the rebound is snatched by Dagstead. Heading left to right. We're the Golden Bears, now heading right to left to the Lake Mills Bulldogs, wearing the road purples tonight. White lettering and numbering on the front and back of their jerseys is inside. It's Moen under the bucket, and she shuffled the shoes. Nice job digging in there on defense by Gracelyn Eastman.
Well, Lake Mills pushes the tempo right off the bat, wasting no time getting the ball up the floor, as we know the Garrigan Bears are going to push that tempo as well.
Bishop Garrigan has been above the 60-point mark in every game so far this season. They've averaged 70.3 points per game as Aulish tried to dump it down low to Capacious. Ball knocked away, though, and taken by Vonick for Lake Mills. The first-team top of Iowa selection last year, running the floor, drives the baseline, looking to reverse. Eastman stays in front. She deals to Moen on the block. Moen dropped it and picked it back up and comes out beyond the perimeter to Reddig. Rotation over to Vonick, steps to the foul line, lobs underneath Moen, seals off Eastman, and drops the layup in. 2-0 Lake Mills.
Very good pass in the interior. You know, of course, most teams always say in their pregame interview, we got to prepare for crooks, but now the inside's a little more open.
Quick drive the other way by Emmy Bartolo, and she'll draw the early foul as the Bishop Garrigan sophomore heads to the charity stripe for two shots.
Yeah, she almost got that bucket to fall. Emmy Bartolo and Tayshia Aulish and Zoe Montag and Abby Capacious all can really drive that ball to the rack well.
Emmy Bartolo off to a great start so far this season. 11.7 points per game for the Golden Bears. She's knocked down 9 of her 18 three-point attempts as right now she converts on the first free throw and gets Bishop Garrigan on the board 2-1. Lake Mills 2-1 on the season. They lost to Newman Catholic 58-49 in the opener as Bartolo misses the second shot off the fingertips of Eastman and secured by Vonick. Lake Mills then beat West Hancock by 10 as there's a pass underneath and laying it up and in is Reddig. 4-1 Bulldogs.
Wow, what a pass by Vonick. Full court pass right on the money. That's a tough thing to do.
Vonick averaged 5.8 assists per game last season. Lake Mills coming off a 44-40 win over Belmont Clemmie. That's their early schedule. 2-1 is Aulish. Gets it outside Capacious. Comes across the foul line and gets it onto the wing to Bartolo. Bartolo wants to drive. Back outside Capacious in front of the Golden Bears student section. Top of the key Montag. Fades right. Heads left. Drives down the lane. Misses the layup. Eastman the cleanup and the finish.
Good cleanup by Eastman. Good drive by Montag. Drove with a purpose. Hard to the basket with her left hand.
Here's Cora Sauer, the Lake Mills freshman. She's been a star so far this season. Gets it out to Vonick as she was falling away. Rotation to the corner to Reddig. Lets a free fly. Missed it a little bit too strong. And Capacious muscles away the rebound. Reddig so far this season struggling on three-pointers. 1-13 coming into tonight. Eastman inside, and she draws the foul. Got great low post position against Moen that time, and that's the second foul against Lake Mills.
Good look. Teams are matching up right now man-to-man, and that enables anyone with an advantage over their opponent to get position like Eastman did there get position and get the ball. Tyler, did you notice when Emmy Bartolo and the freshman for Lake Mills went to the floor? Bartolo helped her up, taking time out of the play. We see that on the football field all the time after the play's over, but that play was still in progress. Bartolo's helping him up.
She knew Graceland Eastman had it under control as Eastman knocks down the free throw, and Bishop Garrigan has their first lead. 5-4 Golden Bears. Here's the full court press. Lake Mills in the backcourt has Dagstead being swarmed by a double team as she bounces to Vonick. Vonick, capacious, almost trapped her there inside of half court. All the way cross court to Redding in the far corner, and she'll get it to Vonick. Vonick on the right wing, guarded by Bartolo. Drives. Eastman with the help defense. Vonick flips it up, though, and flips it in.
Boy, Vonick, unanimous. Going to be all conference. Boy, she has got some offensive skills. Quite a repertoire of moves.
Montag, right wing three-pointer, way too strong. And the rebound tracked down by Sauer. And on a foul. Looks like that was Eastman for Bishop Garrigan picking that one up. It sure was, and that'll be foul number one against the Golden Bears.
It was really nice with these two teams in this high school girls basketball game is that both teams, beginning of the season still, boy, they know what they're doing. They know where to go, they know where to move, and they communicate very well.
This is a Lake Mills team that's looking to make a big jump from last year. They went 9-13 overall, but lost a lot of close games, so if they can turn a couple of those into wins, they may be near the top of the conference. Capacious steals it in the backcourt, finds Aulish, quick trigger on the free, a little bit too strong, rebound, briefly controlled by Lake Mills, knocked out of bounds, last touch by Garrigan. Dagstead almost had that one, but Lake Mills will get it anyways. They will have to run an inbounds play, though, against the Garrigan aggressive full-court press. Capacious will guard the inbounds pass along the baseline. Redding will trigger things into motion. The 5-3 junior bounces it into Vonick. Bartolo with the early assignment on Vonick. Guns it up the court. Knocked away by Aulish, but it's saved by Sauer. Sauer gets underneath to Moen. Moen puts it up. She put it down, and a foul. Chance for a three-point play by Ava Moen.
Really the only option they could do there. Great pass down to Moen inside. The Bears are going to throw a lot of different types of presses at you. That press was all five players are on one side of the backcourt line. And they put all the pressure on the inbounds pass that left them vulnerable deep. Lake Mills almost threw it away, but really just threaded a needle down, got the easy bucket.
Early foul trouble for Graceland Eastman. She checks out with two fouls as Reagan Murphy, the Bishop Garrigan senior, will replace her. From the foul line, it's Moen. Knocks down the free throw and converts the three-point play. 9-5 Lake Mills coming out with energy once again against Bishop Garrigan. If you recall last year, the Audie Crooks, Molly Joyce version of Bishop Garrigan, got in a first-quarter deficit at Lake Mills in the month of December before the game turned around and went in Bishop Garrigan's favor. Aulish, top of the key, has it knocked away, and it's stolen by Lake Mills. Vonick gets it up quickly. She finds Sauer. Sauer right of the lane. Back to the bucket. Turns 360. Tries to find space. Uses the pivot foot. Misses the layup as Capacious snatches another rebound.
Good post-pivot work there by Lake Mills. Garrigan did a nice job not fouling.
Capacious tried to find Murphy underneath. Moen jumped it, but she threw it right back to Capacious along the baseline. Outside to Montag. Lets it rip. Air ball on the three-pointer. Out of bounds. Back to Lake Mills.
Yeah, Montag puts her arms at her side, says, "What was that?" She's not used to seeing that come off top of her hands. She just got to keep shooting, and they'll heat up eventually.
Montag, a 32.5% three-point shooter last season for the Golden Bears, as Capacious almost knocked the inbounds play away, and that'll be a kickball violation going against the Bishop Garrigan senior.
Yeah, she's playing some soccer down there. She put a toe on it. Can't do that, but at least it got your defense reset, so there's nothing wrong with that.
I fully believe Abby Capacious would be a great soccer player if Bishop Garrigan had a soccer team. As Sauer's into the front court, she'll stop for a mid-range jumper, but before she can shoot it, Bartolo runs in the back there, charging down on defense.
You know what else Abby could probably do? She could be a preacher. She opened up Advent at our prayer service, and she was the speaker, and I didn't know what to expect. Dynamite.
So another multi-talented Bishop Garrigan senior. The seniors on the basketball team always do more than just basketball, that's for sure. As from the baseline, Vonick's looking. Vonick lobbing it up to Moen, and she threw it right to Bartolo. Another turnover forced by Bishop Garrigan. Bartolo across the timeline, drifts towards the left wing, and she finds Capacious. Capacious wants to drive. She's into the paint. Back to the bucket. Turns to face it. Puts it up. Missed the hook shot. And Murphy chases it down in the corner and then dropped it out of bounds.
She was already looking to get that ball to Sasha Aulish for an open three-pointer. And it just kind of bounced off her leg while she was thinking ahead. Boy, you'll definitely get hustle when Murphy comes off the bench. Garrigan puts the press in. And that's when they use Murphy. She comes in. She's playing center field right now looking to steal the pass.
So Lake Mills from the sideline. They inbound of Redick. And they get it into the backcourt to Vonick. Vonick surveying the Bishop Garrigan defense. Emma Taft into the ballgame for Lake Mills for the first time tonight, the 6-foot-tall junior. Now she'll replace Moen. Over to the right side, Redick. Now back up top, she'll find Sauer. The freshman Cora Sauer at 5'8", weaves around traffic, puts it up through traffic, and puts it up and in. She powered it over Murphy, who's a little slow getting up right now.
She thinks she took a fist right in the gut, right at the wrong time. I think she got the wind knocked out of her. You know, you get that fist in your diaphragm at the right time. Yeah, she's got her hands up over her head. Yeah, you get the wind knocked out of you. Tyler, I don't think you get the wind knocked out of you very much running around that track in your track meets these days. Anyone ever put you an elbow right in your ribs? I suppose they might. At an 800, you're jockeying for position.
Not enough to get the wind knocked out of me as Alyssa Hoagland checks into the ballgame for Bishop Garrigan. Murphy will take a seat.
So this is an exciting lineup for the Bears. Five guards, I'll call it, in the game right now. We'll see how they creatively score here without the big posts.
Yeah, this could be a chaotic lineup for Bishop Garrigan with a lot of speed on the court. In the far corner, it's Montag. 3:40 on the clock, quarter number one. 11-5, Lake Mills on top. Allish driving in. She attacks and she draws the foul. Not in the act of shooting, but that will be number three against Lake Mills.
Yeah, they're going five out, as you would expect. They're going to drive that ball to the hoop. Got some guards to do it, and the referees realize, you know, we got to start calling some fouls because the girls are getting a little more aggressive as the game wears on both sides, and they want to make sure this game stays clean.
Lake Mills is going to downsize here. The 5'8 Grace Bechtel replaces the 6-foot tall Emma Taft. So Lake Mills adding a little speed on the floor to match up with Bishop Garrigan as Hoagland has it far side of the court. Golden Bears spread out the floor wide of Capacious handling a rock right now. Capacious drives, deals into the corner to Montag. Head fakes, slices into the lane, hooks it up with the left hand and missed it. Offensive rebound for Capacious. She's been averaging 9 boards per game. That one did not hit the rim as Garrigan has 19 on the shot clock. Bartolo drives in left of the lane, scoop layup, missed it. And the rebound snatched by Dagstad. Lake Mills will pace the other way. It's Vonick. Vonick driving and attacks Montag. The rejection by Zoe Montag. And now here comes Garrigan. Garrigan running as Capacious waits. Deals it to Montag in the far side. Lets it fly. That three-pointer's off the heel, no good. Fight for the rebound and a foul against Addie Capacious as she ran over the top of Bechtel.
You know, this five-out offense is working. Bears are in their shot. They've got two drives to the hoop. That was a good open look for Montag. You know, the shots just aren't falling. Nothing to panic by. That's going to be the offense this year. You run and shoot. Sometimes you get cold.
Bishop Garrigan hit 12 three-pointers in each of their first two games. Just 5, though, against Western Christian. As now Vonick races up the floor, trying to get past Dawlish. Vonick backs her way in, lays it up and in. Perfect spin off the glass, and it's 13-5 Lake Mills.
Yeah, Vonick with 4 points early in this contest.
Now Bartolo slices inside and missed on the layup. Came in a little bit out of control as the rebound is secured by Dagstad. Now Vonick running point. Sees Capacious and wings it over to the near side. Finds Bechtel. Getting it into the lane to Sauer. Sauer reverses and puts it off the glass for 2 more. How about Lake Mills up by 10 on the road?
Boy, and they must have hired a post coach as they are putting on some impressive moves from that block, especially on the left side. Great post footwork, pivoting, moving, and using the glass to knock in a bucket.
Coach Schwab takes a 60-second timeout, and we'll take it with him on Hometown Radio KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beisch, Jason Brace, Daniel Folt, and Michael Toth.
Kemco Tires. They're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 Agency. A fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm Insurance Agent in Algona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
BMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Lake Mills girls basketball has not beaten Bishop Garrigan since January 19th of 2016. That's 13 straight wins for the Golden Bears, but right now it's Lake Mills 15, Bishop Garrigan 5, as the Bulldogs made a statement on the road so far. A cold shooting start for Bishop Garrigan as well, as they rotated around the perimeter. Essentially that five-guard lineup you talked about earlier, Beanie is always contested free ball off the back of the cup, and it's chased down by Lake Mills for the rebound, but it's ripped away by Montag. Out to Bartolo, deep three-pointer, too strong. The rebound is taken by Sauer.
And that was deep three-pointer. They're going to let it rain out of this timeout.
Vonick racing the other way, the sidestep, and she'll pass it out to Bechtel. Bechtel works the baseline, finds an open Vonick in the corner, lets it fly, and a little bit short. Rebound, though, for Redding, and back out in the corner to Vonick. Vonick slices across the paint, onto the wing Bechtel, rotates it into the corner, Redding. Free ball, a little bit short, and Montag secures the rebound on the far side.
Montag with a good board. She's playing bigger right now. She's playing very powerful basketball.
Allish, just inside of half court, heads towards her right. Capacious, ready to set the screen up top as Allish flings it over to the wing to Bartolo. Bartolo with the drive, got past Redding, lays it up and lays it in.
Great crossover by Bartolo. Blew right past Redding with her speed, and now the press is getting some trouble.
Bartolo and Capacious trapping Vonick, and a timeout by Coach Van Ruckel and the Lake Mills Bulldogs. 30-second timeout as we'll keep it right here, trying to save a turnover as Vonick got in between that sideline and two defenders, Beanie. That's one of the tenets of the full court press. The sideline is an extra defender.
Yeah, use that sideline, trap them against the sideline and half court line. Tyler, what do you think about this timeout? I feel like it's just perfect timing by Coach Van Rompel for Lake Mills.
Yeah, this is a good timeout right now. You still have momentum early in this one. Garrigan just got a bucket. There's a chance for your team to take a breath and say, hey, they're going to full court press us. They're going to try to score real quick and get back into this. Stay focused on offense. Take care of the basketball. And don't get yourself trapped on the sidelines. So yeah. I think that is a good timeout for perspective check.
Because Coach Schwab, after his timeout, the Bears just came out guns blazing. They said, we're going to shoot and run. And, boy, you could see the intensity amped up. That was the equivalent of a volleyball timeout. Let's slow them down.
Vonick just at the edge of the lane, bouncing it down to Dagstead, back outside to Vonick, into the corner. She'll find Sauer. The freshman has it ripped away by Capacious, and she takes it right out of her hands as Sauer enters the lane. Capacious will bring the ball up across half court. She'll drive. She'll jump stop. She'll put it up. Missed it a little bit strong. Tried to get her own miss, but it's tipped away and taken by Dagstead. Sauer comes the other way. She'll get it over to Vonick. 47 seconds left in the first quarter. 15-7. Lake Mills on top of Bishop Garrigan. Hoagland guards up top against Vonick. The flip over to right to Reddick, now back to Vonick. 38 seconds left in the first, 21 on the shot clock. Vonick back onto the wing to Reddick. Catch and fire three-pointer. Air ball, it's heading out of bounds, and it's off the hands of Sauer.
Oh, that would have been a huge rebound by Sauer, because then Lake Mills would have been able to run out the rest of the quarter and maintain this 15-7 lead they have. But as it is, now the Bears are going to rush up, score that basketball, and break into this lead.
Graceland Eastman checks back into the game as Hoagland checks out. Lake Mills will counter by bringing in the 6-foot-tall junior Emma Taft back off the bench. Taft went to the bench in favor of Bechtel when the Golden Bears went to that smaller lineup. And now the shot clock is off.
Lake Mills just going to play man-to-man here in this last possession. See if they can match up against the Bears. And that's advantage by the Bear guards, who I think have the speed to blow by him here.
Bartolo dribbling just inside of the half-court line. She'll bring it towards the center of the court. Guarded by Reddick. Bartolo passes right to Montag. 10 on the clock. Now up top to Capacious. Looking inside. In the middle of the lane, Eastman. Takes one dribble. Puts it up. Shot blocked. It was rejected by Taft. Ball out of bounds. Touched by Eastman with 3.9 seconds on the clock as Lake Mills gets it back.
Well, wow, that's a good pass into Eastman, but better defense by Lake Mills. Both teams doing really nice interior defense the last couple possessions.
Yeah, Taft doing a great job digging into the lane and not giving up any ground to Eastman. Vonna catches. She has 2 seconds. She has 1 second. Driving all the way. The floater at the buzzer. And just missed it left. Vonna covered a ton of ground on that one, but could not get the shot to fall at the end of the first quarter. Still a great start by Lake Mills. They lead 15-7 here at Bishop Garrigan High School on KLGA 92.7 and at the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you gotta go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions. Satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op. Delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump It. They do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Albert Electric. Flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Grassmasters. Growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments, quality apartments for rent, beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts, open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Back inside the Bishop Garrigan High School Gymnasium. It's Lake Mills 15 and Bishop Garrigan 7 as we begin the second quarter. Vonick has the basketball for Lake Mills, directing traffic up top. Vonick coming off a season where she scored 308 points last year as she'll bounce it to the near side. Finding Bechtel, now back to Vonick. Golden Bears have dropped into a zone defense, pass down to the baseline, nearly thrown out of bounds. Dagstead gets it. Wild layup up and it misses. Montag had the rebound briefly. It's knocked away and last touched by Montag.
Dagstead, nice catch on that last pass by Vonick. Tyler, at the end of the quarter, Vonick got the ball with 3.5 seconds left, was able to cover the entire court and almost get a layup. That's pretty impressive speed.
Catching an inbounds pass is Dagstead, puts it off the window and scores. Lake Mills keeps the foot on the gas pedal and they're back up by 10. Yeah, Vonick ended up covering nearly the full court, got a floater out from the foul line, but couldn't knock it down before the end of the quarter. Vonick right now sitting on 4 points. Montag tries again on three, and this time she swishes it.
Oh, I knew they were going to go down eventually. She's playing with a lot of power, so is Abby Capacious. You know, if the power index has gone down for the Garrigan team because of the loss of Crooks and Joyce, those two are the ones that are going to pick it up, and there goes Capacious with a steal.
Capacious steals a pass in the corner, and Bishop Garrigan has it. Golden Bears have knocked down 40% of their three-point tries so far this season. They were just under 33% last year as Aulish weaves across the foul line, drives in, and kicks it out to Montag. She shoots again and missed that one strong. Rebound, though, for Capacious and gets it outside to Bartolo. Catch and fire three. That one misses right. Rebound, Eastman. Eastman marooned on the baseline and tried to get to Montag in the corner, but Bechtel knocked it out of bounds and prevented another catch and shoot three opportunity.
Well, it'll just go down on the books as another tally mark, but that was a great rebound by Eastman. Gracklin there got under the back to back with her opponent and was able to keep her balance with a lot of pushing down there. Good job.
Eastman in three games, 47 points and 21 rebounds so far for Bishop Garrigan as she hands it off to Montag. Flips it over to the right to Bartolo. Bartolo across the lane, now back out to Eastman. Eastman finds Montag on the wing, pumps right, drives down the lane. Montag on the attack, missed the layup. The cleanup by Eastman, no good. Rebound tipped around, and Lake Mills able to secure it with Dagstead. Then she throws it away right to Aulish, and the ball's knocked out of bounds. It was last touched by Garrigan. Coach Van Ruvel had her hands on her head for a second, saying, we just gave away possession, but it ended up working out.
It did work out, boy. A lot of helter-skelter play in that last possession. Good hustle by both teams fighting for the ball.
Vonick brings it across half court. One of two seniors in the starting lineup for Lake Mills, and her pass is out of the reach of Dagstead off her fingertips as Capacious comes up with the basketball. Capacious hands it off to Montag on the wing, flips it inside Eastman in the paint, puts it up to the right hand, and she draws the foul. Emma Taft, the guilty party, as Gracelyn Eastman will shoot two.
Freshman almost got a chance for a three-point play as it goes around and out. Senior Capacious is right there to keep her encouraged. You know, Gracelyn Eastman doesn't really play like a freshman. I don't think anyone's keeping track of what grade is anyone on this team because they're all so young, yet freshman, sophomore, junior, senior for Garrigan in the game right now.
Eastman now 3 of 3 at the free-throw line after knocking the first one down. She came into tonight just 9 of 18, but looking good from the foul line so far as the second one drops through as well. 17-12, Bishop Garrigan has trimmed the Lake Mills lead down to 5. This is a 5-0 scoring spurt by Bishop Garrigan as Lake Mills navigates the full court press of Sauer. Sauer finds a wide open player, Taft, under the bucket, and she lays it up and in.
Wow, textbook press break by Lake Mills. Garrigan even had the made free throw with a chance to set it up just how they wanted it and did not work out for them.
19-12 Bulldogs. Capacious has it near side. Cora Sauer in three games, 50 points, 24 rebounds, and 13 assists, all of those leading Lake Mills. And as a freshman, Montag, deep left wing three, she swishes it. Zoe Montag from way downtown.
Oh, what a shot by Montag. Cuts the lead to 4. Just a moment ago, it was 10.
Dagstead trapped in the corner, but finds Vonick along the sideline, and they break the press. They get it up ahead to Bechtel. Bechtel drives in. Bechtel puts it up and in.
Wow, Bechtel with some speed. This Lake Mills team has great team speed all around.
Bartolo flips it near side to Zoe Montag. Well, Coach Van Ruckel is all about speed. She's a cross-country coach as well, and Lake Mills' boys team won the state title this past season in cross-country, so speed is something that works well at Lake Mills as Easton has it inside and back out to Montag. Catch and fire three. Pops out, no good, and Taft grabs the rebound.
Well, Tyler, I really appreciate your cross-country advertisements throughout these basketball games.
I've got to mix it in throughout the season. Bechtel along the baseline, flips it into the paint to Taft, but through to Aulish. Lake Mills playing fast, but they've coughed up a few turnovers so far as Aulish approaches the left wing with 4:43 on the clock. She'll back it up into the left corner and now gets to Capacious. Capacious will survey the Lake Mills defense, heads right around the perimeter and gives it off to Bartolo. Bartolo inside Eastman. Eastman catches. Shot blocked, but a foul. Taft getting called again for that one. That's foul number 2 against Lake Mills of the quarter.
Well, the Bears are persistent, doing a nice job getting it inside to Eastman, and she's going to the line. Now, like we said before, if she can make these free throws, then Garrigan has a nice chance to set up their press and get in position.
Eastman has not had a lot of easy looks in the lane tonight as she knocks down the first free throw. Lake Mills has either fouled her or forced really tough shots inside, which I'm sure is the goal against the 5'11 freshman. Reagan Murphy in as Capacious checks out.
Yeah, Capacious has yet to get a break. And when you're full court pressing and you're a guard, boy, you get tired pretty quick. And that's a quarter and a couple for Capacious.
Eastman good again. She's perfect at the foul line tonight, 6 for 6. And it's a 21-17 lead by Lake Mills.
Yeah, boy, that is a recipe for success. If you're Coach Schwab, you say, yes, get the ball to Eastman. It's a physical game. We'll get foul calls and get her to the line because she is really on fire from the free throw line, which is not a given, Tyler. Free throws aren't free.
Bonick has it up top. Bishop Garrigan playing that 2-3 zone right now in the high post. Sauer faces the bucket, gets by Murphy, floats it off the glass and scores.
Just not moving defensively. A lot of trees standing around for the Garrigan defense.
Bartolo backs it out to the left wing, passes right to Olish. Murphy will set a screen. Olish won't use it though, she'll head left. Down to 4 minutes in the first half. Eastman just to the right of center, working with the dribble, stopping at the foul line, coming out to Montag. Another deep tray, and that's an air ball. She left it short. Murphy tries to shovel it back in, but she tapped it right to Lake Mills' Ava Moen. Lake Mills will run. Here comes Vonick. Vonick drifts towards the far side of the court and picks up her dribbles. Bartolo stays in front, pivots 360 and gets to Sauer. 3:42 on the clock. Sauer tried to throw it into the post, and it's intercepted by Eastman. 3-on-1 for Garrigan. Eastman bounces to Bartolo. Right back to Eastman. Lays it up and lays it in.
That was fun to watch. Three Bears running side by side like a three-man weave, except Eastman dribbled all the way down. A give and go under the hoop.
10 points by Graceland Eastman, and a well-executed fast break by the Golden Bears as Moen has it along the perimeter, wings it out to the near side. As you'll find Kate Bechtel. Kate Bechtel getting her first run tonight. Grace Bechtel played earlier as Redig bounces it to the top of the key to Sauer. Flips it over to the right to Moen. Moen gets to the baseline of 10 on the shot clock. Back out top to Vonick. Two players jump at her as Vonick goes right. 7 on the shot clock. Moen three ball. Rolls off the cup. No good. Rebound taken by Zoe Montag. The Bishop Garrigan Jr. has it and hands it off to Emmy Bartolo. Bartolo sidearm pass inside Eastman. Eastman heads right, takes a wide angle, and she spun it in.
Good footwork, good post move. That looked like a 6-on-6 move in, from the olden days. The old two steps and up off the glass.
23-21, Lake Mills' 10-point lead is now down to 2 as Bishop Garrigan has had a good second quarter offensively after scoring just 7 points in the first quarter. Bounce pass to Moen, working deep in the post. Bangs it off the window. She fades away. No good. And Eastman with a fingertip rebound. Bartolo outlets up to Olish near side. Olish catches. Lets it fly. And missed it a little bit strong. Rebound tracked down by Eastman. Back up to Bartolo. She'll shoot the three. She'll swish the three. And Bishop Garrigan's on top, 24-23.
You bet. They just wore them down. Lake Mills got a little tired here. And the Bears are making them run around, leaving wide open shooters.
The three balls are starting to drop. And now Lake Mills trying to grab some momentum back in the final 2 minutes. 1:58 left in the first half. On the right wing, it's Redig. Redig looking for Moen in the high post. Knocked away by Olish. Great hands, and Bartolo has it. Bartolo lobs it up to Olish. Drifts towards the far side of the court as Bishop Garrigan leads by 1. Olish sets herself. Launches a 3. Way too strong. Hit just glass. Moen had the rebound briefly, but deflected away. Back out to Olish. Passed up an open 3 look this time as she'll work the offense. She'll drive instead. She'll lay it up. She puts it in of a ton of English. What a move by Olish.
Yeah, boy, the Bears just have such great awareness where that hoop is. The coach for Lake Mills says, timeout. We blew a 10-point lead, and now we're down 3. We better talk about this. Just a 30-second timeout here for the coach. But if anything, your players need a break. They've had turnovers just because they're not going to the ball off passes, and the Bears are just stepping in front of passes. Moen in the post has had 2 picked off just because you didn't go to the ball. Like, they got to pick up their energy level because the Bears certainly have.
Yes, energy is a big, big factor on a night like tonight, and the Golden Bears have brought it here in the second quarter, leading 26-23. Last year when these two teams matched up, Bishop Garrigan had the edge 78-29 and 73-39. Lake Mills is a team. They were scoring about 51 points per game last year, so right on that average right now. But, again, they played some really good competition early in the season in the top of Iowa West. When you look at a West Hancock team that's typically pretty strong and a Belmont-Clemmy team with Addie Lamb and won both those games. As Lake Mills brings Dagstead back into the ball game. Bishop Garrigan with Alyssa Hoagland and Emmy Bartolo set to play the top of that 2-3 zone if they stay in that. Olish Capacious and Murphy at the bottom of it. As Vonick will walk it across half court. 1.5 minutes left in the first quarter. Vonick gets to the foul line, passes right to Sauer. Now back to Vonick up top. Vonick rips the pass near side to Redig with 1:14 on the clock. Redig, 3 dribbles towards the right, heads around the perimeter, keeps dribbling and hands it off right back to Sauer. Sauer on the wing, looking back to the near side to Vonick, trying to shift the Golden Bear defense around. Dagstead scrapping for Post position inside, can't find it. Now she'll get it beyond the perimeter of 5 seconds. Five on the shot clock. Knocked away by Sauer, she picks it back up. 50 seconds left in the quarter, 31 on the shot clock. Emmy Bartolo goes over to Hoagland. Hoagland lets it fly, and it's a little bit too strong. Capacious rebound under the bucket, and back out to Hoagland. 6 second difference between game clock and shot clock. Always looking to drive in. Scoops layup and missed it. Murphy follows. Murphy misses. Got her own miss. And she got fouled with 31 seconds left in the half.
Boy, the second quarter, the rebounding has been just dominated by the Bears. And that is a sign that your team is just getting tired. The first quarter, Lake Mills is battling for everything. The second quarter, they're just a little tired. And you get tired, you start to not make that extra step. You start to just reach. And boy, Reagan Murphy just battled hard for two offensive rebounds.
Murphy lines up the foul shot and puts it in. 27-23, Bishop Garrigan as the run continues. Reese Kemna into the ball game as Hoagland will check out.
Wait, excellent free throw shooting by the Bears. I hope it didn't just jinx Reagan Murphy. But that is a really good sign for the season shooting.
And Murphy knocks it down. No jinx here, ladies and gentlemen. And Bishop Garrigan with their largest lead of the night so far, 28-23. Lake Mills can now work it for the last shot as Vonick dribbles just inside of half court. Kemna and Bartolo up top as Kemna comes up to defend. Vonick unloads it right to Reddick. Now back to Vonick with 17 on the game clock. A high screen is coming for Lake Mills as Dagstead sets it. Reddick has it right side, now flings it back to the left. As the pass goes down to the baseline, jumper on the way, Bechtel no good, knocked out of bounds. And who touched it last? Murphy touched it last of 6 seconds left.
Now they're going to have a chance to execute a play here. Chance for Lake Mills to cut into this five-point lead, cut it to three right before half if they can execute.
Bishop Garrigan will keep their back to the inbounder as Vonick lobs it in and finds Sauer. Sauer heads right with 5 seconds, flings it into the corner to Reddick, drives baseline and a foul. That's a blocking foul on Reagan Murphy, but the first foul of the quarter by Bishop Garrigan. So 1.7 seconds left and Lake Mills will inbound again.
Now, definitely was a thinker by the official. You know, you need a replay to really get that one right. I don't know right or wrong, but it was a tough one. It's about as close as you can get between a charge and a block.
Vonick looking, lobbing in at 1.7 to Sauer, right back to Vonick, and Vonick's going to run out of time. Nice defense by Garrigan at the end of the quarter, and Bishop Garrigan has turned this game around. 180 as we head to halftime. Bishop Garrigan 28 and Lake Mills 23 on KLGA 92.7 and the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
Thank you to these sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Kossuth Regional Health Center, make KRHC your home for health care.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, carrying steel and Toro products and Green Mountain pellet grills.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Runke Brothers Full Service. Experience the Runke Brothers difference for all your auto service and repair needs.
Erpelding Boyd & Company CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Hy-Vee, use the Fuel Saver card. Fill your cart, fuel your car.
North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Algona, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Erpelding Excavating Enterprises, let them take care of your grading, excavating, and drainage needs.
AK's Chrome Kitchen. When you come in, your family.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
For over 40 years, Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons have maintained one mission: to provide excellence in orthopedic care. Their team of 9 physicians offer specialized care in everything from arthroscopic same-day surgery to joint replacement, as well as hand and foot surgery, and have an orthopedic surgeon on call 24/7. Healthcare isn't about appointments, it's about taking care of people, and that's their specialty. Visit Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons on the web at nwiabone.com. Players!
Already halftime here at Bishop Garrigan High School as the Golden Bears lead the Lake Mills Bulldogs 28-23. Bishop Garrigan was down 15-7 at the end of one, but a 21-7 scoring advantage by the Golden Bears in the second quarter has turned this game into a 5-point Bishop Garrigan advantage. Scoring-wise, a couple leading scores look like this. Graceland Eastman of 12 points for Bishop Garrigan, Emmy Bartolo and Zoe Montag of 6 apiece. On the Lake Mills side, Cora Sauer has 6 and Taylor Vonick of 4, the 2 leading scorers for Lake Mills. But Beanie, you know, a lot of things went better in the second quarter than the first for Bishop Garrigan. I I want to start with defensively. They forced, you know, quite a few turnovers in the second quarter. Lake Mills had trouble getting the ball into the post, and really a much better defensive performance in quarter number two than quarter number one.
Yeah, for sure. You know, and the Bears showed no sign of worry when they were down by 10, because that's the style of game they're going to play. They know they're going to score in spurts when someone gets hot and the threes start falling, and they're going to give up some points and give up some leads. But, boy, they really did well staying the course there. And generally, Tyler, these high school girls' basketball games, ball handling prevails above all else. Shooting, conditioning, that's all important. But the team that handles the ball better is usually going to win. And Lake Mills faltered, turned the ball over a few times, and Garrigan didn't. And that's the difference.
That is the difference. As right now, Bishop Garrigan leads 28-23 at the half. Before we talk more about the girls' game, though, we're going to preview the guys' game. Here's assistant coach Tyler Tiffany is checking in with us right now. Coach, we'll let you get a headset on here as you settle in. But obviously a big Top of Iowa West game coming up tonight against Lake Mills, something that really gets the guys excited. So just talk to me about the intensity that Lake Mills versus Bishop Garrigan normally brings.
Yeah, I mean, it goes back to when I started here 4 years ago. You know, it's always a tough matchup. You know, I would call it a rivalry. It's just you get two good teams and two good programs coming together and playing against each other, and it's a battle. It's a battle for sure, and it's fun. It's fun to be a part of it.
This is always an early December matchup, you know, early in the season for you guys against Lake Mills. So you get one of the first cracks in the conference at them to see what Lake Mills has coming into the season. And, you know, kind of looking through their lineup, some of the players that stand out. Aiden Stensrud's one of the big ones. He's been scoring about 30 points per game for the first two. You know, specifically of him, what are some of the challenges that he presents to you guys tonight?
He gets after it. He gets after it on both sides of the court. And it's hard to defend guys like that for for, you know, 32 minutes of the game. And he just, I mean, there's, his motor is, it doesn't stop, and we have to match that, and we have to get above that to, you know, stop him. You're not going to stop guys like that, you know, but you can contain them, and you can do certain things, certain ways, you know, to slow them down a little bit. And like I said, you're not going to stop guys like that, but I mean, there's things you can do to slow them down, you know, but it's, guys like that, it's hard, and they got shooters around, you know, and shooters and guards, they have experience. They have guys that play, you know, they've played all 4 years, you know, a couple seniors, few seniors actually. So yeah, I mean, they're a problem, and I feel that we have in our short time together, I feel like we have prepared well for this, and this is a matchup we look forward to for sure.
Well, Coach, one thing that's exciting for you guys right now is the improvement of Michael Joyce. He had a big scoring game this past weekend against Western Christian of 23 points. He was the team's leading scorer. You know, how have you really seen him command that starting role as a freshman?
He's a confident individual, he's fun to be around. He's a learner. He likes to learn. He likes to listen. Listening is a big thing coming into this environment, you know, but he always wants to get better. He's always asking, you know, what can I do, or how about this, or how about that, or, you know, he's very, very coachable, very easy to talk to, and he's confident, and he loves to compete.
Well, Coach, wrapping up for today, what do you feel the biggest key for a Bishop Garrigan victory in this game is?
We got to match intensity right away. We're at home tonight, and we know that they're going to come out fired up, and we need to match that intensity. Once we match that intensity, everything else will fall into play, and it'll be a good game tonight.
Well, Coach, we wish you the best of luck tonight, and thank you for stopping by.
Thanks, Tyler.
That's Assistant Coach Tyler Tiffany talking Bishop Garrigan boys basketball as they will play Lake Mills following the conclusion of the girls' game. We'll step aside for another timeout here on KLGA and come back after this with the second half of the Lake Mills versus Bishop Garrigan girls' game. It's coming up on 92.7.
Thank you to these sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Kossuth Regional Health Center, make KRHC your home for healthcare.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, carrying steel and Toro products and Green Mountain pellet grills.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Runke Brothers Full Service. Experience the Runke Brothers difference for all your auto service and repair needs.
Purple Ding Boyd & Company CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Hy-Vee, use the Fuel Saver card, fill your cart, fuel your car.
North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Algona, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Herpling Excavating Enterprises, let them take care of your grading, excavating, and drainage needs.
AK's Chrome Kitchen, when you come in, your family.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
At Security State Bank, we realize each customer has a unique set of needs and goals. That's why we place a greater value on providing outstanding customer service. All products and services are designed for customers within our local community. We value each customer that walks through our door and wants to give them the personalized attention they deserve. Find out why Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne is your partner in community banking. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Security State Bank.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
Farmers State Bank is proud to be part of our community. Offices in Algona, Whittemore, and West Bend.
Stroman Dental, giving you something to smile about.
Bill's Auto and Truck Repair. Service is the difference.
Trend Salon, your complete family hair salon. It's all about you.
Oakcrest Funeral Services, celebrating a life lived.
Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident.
Water Connection, from softeners to bottled water and service, call 295-SOFT.
Algona Pizza Ranch, there's so much to love.
Cotton Grave Farm Management and Land Realty in downtown Algona, trusted for farmland service needs since 1960.
Sponsoring this broadcast on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
The second half of basketball action on Hometown Radio KLGA and the Algona Radio YouTube live stream. Tyler Lance alongside Beanie Bodie is right now. Bishop Garrigan leads Lake Mills 28-23 in this top of Iowa West battle at halftime. Beanie, I think a big theme in the first half was playing fast and trying to keep it under control. There were times for both teams where they were fast and in control, and there were times where they were fast but out of control. So being under control, taking care of the basketball in the second half, and executing that full court press going to be keys for the victor in tonight's game.
Yeah, and you know, your confidence level. Lake Mills started the game full of confidence going to the hoop, and then it faltered, and then Garrigan increased their confidence, especially with Eastman down inside calling for the ball, and Montag starting to heat it up, and Bartolo and Alish, boy, they're always confident that the next shot is going to drop. And of course Capacious rock steady senior in there. Like, they're just a solid team, and they're really hard to defeat as long as they stay confident.
Bishop Garrigan will start the second half with the basketball, heading from right to left on the radio dial as Capacious opens up the drive, bangs her way inside and draws a foul. Aggressive move by Abby Capacious, took it right to the body of Dagstad, and the Bishop Garrigan senior will shoot two.
Yeah, Abby is not called upon to do that so much this year. Usually it's Bartolo and Alish up top driving to the hoop, and Abby's there for the rebound, but Coach Schwab starts the half, decides let's inbound it to Abby. Abby just take it to the hoop, and she does just that, but misses her first free throw.
Rare free throw miss by Capacious, who shot 78% from the line last season. Capacious actually had a career high of 20 points a couple of years ago against Lake Mills in the 2021-2022 season, as she scored 20 points during an 80-33 win and splits the pair at the foul line, knocks it down to make it 29-23, Bishop Garrigan, as she has her first point of the night. On the right wing, Korsauer, the Lake Mills freshman, wings it all the way across to Vonick. Vonick looks inside, but Garrigan not letting anyone get post positioning on the inside as Lake Mills rotates around the perimeter to Redig. Redig on the near side of the court. 17 on the shot clock. Passes left to Vonick. Vonick backwards to the right to Redig. Looking inside, lobs it into Moen. Eastman stays in front. Knocked away by Montag. Ball loose on the floor. Eastman dives on it. It's going to be a tie-up here and a jump ball.
Boy, after accusing them of standing around like trees during a possession in the first half, Garrigan's 2-3 has come to life and is really moving a lot better, especially in that possession. Wow, they were everywhere.
7:20 on the clock, quarter number three. Vonick picks up the dribble and flips it over to Redig. Redig drives baseline, Capacious stays in front. A nice floater by Redig, and it's good. 29-25, Bishop Garrigan's lead back down to 4 points as Bartolo brings it across half court and comes right to Alish. Stacia Aulish had a career high of 28 points a couple games ago against Belmont Clemmy. Took 18 three-pointers in that game as she had the ultimate green light. Now Montag on the left wing, heads right around the perimeter, flips it over to Bartolo on the right side. Now back up to the top of the key to Capacious. Lob inside Eastman, catches, puts it up and scores!
Splits the defenders, good step through move.
The DNA of a team just doesn't change. Bishop Garrigan continues to get post touches for their center. This time it's Graceland Eastman instead of Audie Crooks last year, but they have found Eastman inside frequently tonight for 14 points. Montag jumps in front of a pass and knocks that along the baseline with 6:33 on the clock.
Yeah, now Garrigan's up by six. That's tough because you know they can come back in a hurry, but when they have a lead, they'll start pounding it inside, and that makes them very, very tough for Lake Mills to come back.
Sauer in the right corner, rotates it around to Vonick, now Reddick. Reddick drives, ball knocked away by Bartolo, loose on the floor, and it rolls out to Sauer. Sauer sidesteps into a long jumper just inside the perimeter, left it short. Eastman rebounds, and a foul on Lake Mills.
Gonna get called for a push in the back of Eastman. Garrigan will walk it up the floor here with Bartolo and Capacious.
Dagstead picks that one up, her second personal foul, and the second team foul on Lake Mills of this third quarter. As we approach the 6:15 mark, Capacious brings it across half court, drives to the right side of the paint, turns it back to the bucket and underhands it to Eastman. Eastman charging in, wraps the pass around to Bartolo. Corner pocket Trey, in and out, no good. Rebound rolls loose. It's Bonnie's diving to the floor and a jump ball. Bartolo getting tied up of Sauer.
There's a 50-50 ball. Who's going to get it? And the Bears got that one. Holding on to this 6-point lead, going to stretch it out here with this inbounds play. They're going four low.
They lob it into Capacious, just outside of the perimeter. Eastman posting up inside, catches in the center of the paint. Power dribbles, puts it off the window, rolls off the cup, no good. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Bishop Garrigan.
Yeah, so that four low, Capacious pops up high to the top of the key. They throw it into her, and she goes right back down to Eastman. Just a two-player game. And Capacious then nearly gets the rebound. And, boy, two on five there, and Garrigan still gets a good shot on goal.
And Coach Schwab campaigning right now. I think he's saying Dagstead touched it last, but I believe the referee said Capacious was the last person to touch the basketball. As Lake Mills leads by six, bouncing it into the corner to Sauer. Sauer takes a couple dribbles and then gets it left to Vonick. Vonick fighting against Aulish, threads the needle inside to Dagstead, and a foul on Bishop Garrigan. That one's on the floor, and the first foul of the quarter by Bishop Garrigan.
Nice drive and a good interior pass from guard to post there for Lake Mills. On the floor here, can they execute an inbounds play? Garrigan sitting in their 2-3 inbounds.
Vonick to trigger. Vonick gets it into Reddick, who backs up near half court. 5:34 on the clock. Garrigan has played primarily 2-3 zone after the first few minutes of the ball game. The handoff goes to Vonick. Vonick on the right wing. Golden Bears not letting her get a three-point look off. She sends a cross-court feed to Reddick. Reddick wants to drive. Golden Bears collide. Reddick puts it up, rolls off the cup, and Capacious chases down the rebound. I think Montag and Aulish knocked heads on the far side as Montag hands it off to Bartolo. Brings it up towards the top of the key. Gives it off to Montag with 5:01 on the clock, quarter number three, 31-25 Bishop Garrigan. Capacious wants to drive, staying in front of good defense as Dagstead, and Capacious has to work it back out to Montag. Montag drives in, scoops layup up, and it's blocked. Moen got a hand on it, and Lake Mills has the ball.
And Montag took a pretty good shot when they collided there. She's looking a little bit dazed. She always does a really nice ball fake and continue to do that, but the drive didn't look there. She might have some swelling going on that right eyeball.
The floater by Vonick is left short, and Eastman rips the rebound away from everyone. Now Bartolo of pace finds Aulish, who backs it up. Step back three-pointer on the way, off the back of the cup, and Aulish just ran over Sauer and committed the foul. That'll be foul number two against Bishop Garrigan as the offense has ticked to a stop here in the third quarter.
Murphy's going to check back in here, and they're going to, I think, have a look there. Eastman's coming out. So Murphy for Eastman. Bears choosing not to press here, up 6 points. They're going to set up their 2-3 defense, which has been great this third quarter. Lake Mills having a hard time getting any good looks at the basket. And Tyler, they are just not getting any rebounds. Garrigan dominating the board since halftime.
Garrigan has been dominating the boards as Lake Mills brings in the two Bechtels, sophomore Kate Bechtel and sophomore Grace Bechtel, replacing Reddick and Dogstad on the lineup. 4:17 left in the third quarter, 31-25 Bishop Garrigan, and the pass is sailed over the head of Bechtel and out of bounds. Turnover by Sauer, and Bishop Garrigan gets it back.
So this zone by Garrigan, just no different than last year. Very difficult to reverse the ball over on the top of the key without turning it over. They tried to go across court, and overthrew the ball, just a forced turnover.
Now Capacious tees up the three-point ball, in and out as she can't knock it down from the left wing. Capacious, her sophomore year, led the top of Iowa West in three-point percentage. Doesn't take a whole lot as she was 7 of 20 last year. Down into the post, Dagstead trying to go up and under against Murphy, but Murphy turns it off. Now back out to Bechtel. Bechtel skip feeds it across. It's knocked away by Montag. Ball rolls loose in Lake Mills, able to save the possession. In the corner, Sauer lets a free ball go, and she rainbows an air ball as it was last touched by Lake Mills going out of bounds.
Wait, Lake Mills just not being able to make that cross-court pass, and it's tough. You throw it over the top of all these people. You've got a student section right there. Don't want to be short with the pass. Don't want to be long with the pass. Difficult to drop that in. Eastman back in the game. Murphy checks back out. Bartolo's going to walk the ball up the floor. Bears haven't scored in quite a few. 2 minutes without a score here, at least for the Bears. They need a bucket to get off the schneid.
Bishop Garrigan is just 3 points in this quarter so far, leading 31-25. Montag lets it fly. She buries it. 34-25.
Another long three-pointer from Montag.
Well, now Bishop Garrigan outscoring Lake Mills 6-2 in this third quarter, up 34-25. Bechtel gives it off to Vonick. Vonick heads left around the perimeter, spins right against Bartolo, and passes right to Bechtel just inside the three-point line. Back to Vonick, guarded by Alsh on the wing. Now driving in and getting a shot block as Sauer. Eastman erased it. Lob up to Alsh. Alsh working around Vonick, scoops the layup up, and he draws the foul. That might have been a little bailout there as Alsh was careening towards the baseline, but Vonick called for that one, and two free throws on the way.
She was. She was contorting her body, twisting in the air, and then she just threw it up there with her right hand. She says, thank you very much, Mr. Official, because I needed that one.
Sasha Alsh heading to the line for two free throws, scoring 22 points per game so far this year. She knocks that one down. And Bishop Garrigan has extended their lead to 10 points, 35-25. 3 points on the board right now by Alsh. Alsh came into tonight shooting over 45% on three-pointers as she knocks in a free throw, and Bishop Garrigan is up by 11 now. 36-25, 2:55 left in the third quarter. Golden Bears looking for their 14th straight win against Lake Mills, dating back to 2016. Overcoming the early 15-5 deficit. Bounce pass down low. Bechtel hits it off the bottom of the backboard. Make the Dagstead as the Garrigan Bears lob it up the court to Alsh. In the corner, Capacious trying to set a screen, and Capacious will get it in the left corner. Capacious into Eastman. Knocked away, though. Good defense by Lake Mills, and they force the turnover. Bechtel with the knockaway. 2:25 left in the third quarter. Spinning, putting it up to the right hand, drawing a foul and putting it in. Flurry of moves by Kate Bechtel on a chance for a three-point play.
Boy, they have been trying to get that ball inside, finally get some success. They've been making these passes that were just perfect in between two Bear defenders, just couldn't get buckets to go. They get one there, chance to go for a three-point play. That's a third foul on Eastman, so she's going to have to come out. Murphy comes right back in, and Eastman has the lion's share of the Garrigan points with 14 points in this game. So they're going to miss her inside presence, but Murphy, of course, will pick up the speed factor when she gets in that game.
Bechtel misses the free throw right as Capacious sails in for the rebound. Since that 15-5 start by Lake Mills, Bishop Garrigan has a big scoring edge of 31-12 as the three-point ball on the way misses long by Montag. That's cleaned up by Capacious, and Capacious is hacked. Bechtel fouled her on the way back up. Foul number four against Lake Mills, and Capacious will shoot two.
Just the unsung hero here in the rebounding category for the Bears. As you said, Tyler, averaging coming in with nine a game.
Nine a game, yeah.
You know, and she was not far off that last year with Crooks taking a good share of the rebounds off the glass. Capacious is just a rebounding machine, and that's nothing new.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Capacious had eight per game last year. And like you said, Crooks double-digit rebounding as Capacious knocks down the free throw. And she had the big 12 rebounds in that state championship game against Newell Fonda as Bishop Garrigan won their second straight title. Taft checking in. Dagstead checking out for Lake Mills. Bishop Garrigan back up by double digits, 37-27. Capacious ready. And good again, 38-27. And a full timeout called on the floor. We'll take a timeout as well on Hometown Radio KLGA and at the Elgota Radio YouTube live stream.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Algona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle. passionate about teaching, creative about dance, visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Algona and Armstrong, keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
Signworks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Algona Tree Service.
Sports Club members bringing you this game.
Out of the Coach Schwab timeout. Oh. Bishop Garrigan leads Lake Mills 38-27.
I am very surprised. I thought Coach Schwab called the timeout so he could set up a press and come back out and really put on the pressure, but it's sticking in his half court 2-3, and why not? It's working.
Down inside to Taft. Ball went between her hands. It's heading towards the baseline and picked up by Vodick before it goes out of bounds. 1:55 left in the third quarter. Bartolo knocks a cross-court pass away. Bechtel flags it down in the backcourt. And over and back. Boy, Lake Mills is saying that ball was tipped, and I think they may be right about that.
I think they're right, and I think the Lake Mills player touched it, but she certainly never had control of it. So you have to establish control. So the officials explain to the coach right now, but I think they're at an impasse. I think you're right, Tyler. I think the Lake Mills coaches are correct. I don't think she had possession of it, but this is one of those cases where the umpire called a strike, and they're not going to change their mind.
Well, with 1:50 left, barring a major change of heart here, Bishop Garrigan will have the basketball back. Defensively, Beanie, what's working well for the Golden Bears? Because since that 15-5 early scoring advantage, Lake Mills has only scored 12 more points.
Well, they're moving out to the perimeter and then back to the lane really well. Lake Mills can move the ball around, and as soon as someone tries to drive, they're doing a really nice job collapsing and defending that lane, not letting Vonick thread into that lane and do that awesome offense that she's got.
Bishop Garrigan with the basketball. There was no change of heart as Montag has it down on the right corner as Capacious tries to post up inside. Top of the key to Bartolo. She'll get the screen from Capacious. She'll head right and give it off to Montag. 1:33 left in the quarter. Montag picks up her dribble at the foul line. Turns 360. Now back to the bucket. Looking for Bartolo to cut. Bartolo lobs it into Murphy. Murphy in traffic. Draws the foul.
Well, Murphy back to the free throw line. I'm sure she likes to score that way at the free throw lane. Lake Mills crowd counting 3 seconds. Montag was using a pivot foot right there at the high post, had 1 foot inside the free throw line and 1 foot outside. I don't know what to call that one, but she was there for a few seconds.
Murphy at the charity stripe again, missed on the first one. It's not going to be an assist for Bartolo, but she's been passing the ball extremely well this year, 4 assists per game, and that was a nice find of Murphy in traffic. A lot of the tendency might have been to shoot it in that position, but Coach Schwab always says, pass up a good shot for a better shot. And that's what the Golden Bears have done as Murphy knocks that one in to make it 39-27.
Yeah, and they can all score. Like he said in the pregame interview, anyone on this lineup can score. Alish comes out. She's been the leading scorer so far this season. But in comes Hoagland, who can also fire 3 balls through the net. Like, they can all score at any given time.
Bechtel on the wing, gets the screen from Bechtel. Both Bechtels in the ball game right now for Lake Mills. Backing it up is Sauer. She gives it off to Bechtel in the corner. It's Grace Bechtel with the ball. She loses it, and Bartolo picks it up and takes it in stride. Here comes Garrigan in transition. Montag left open for a three-point try, and it rattles in! Fourth free ball of the game by Zoe Montag, and it's 42-27.
Montag with 12 all on three-point shots, and they've all been big.
Lake Mills the other way. Sauer. Backs it up a couple of steps with 49 seconds left in the quarter. Down to the right to Vonick. Underneath Taft. Taft misses off the glass. Took a tough angle that time. Offensive rebound, Dagstead. And a whistle and a foul. This one goes against Garrigan. Their fourth team foul of the quarter.
You know, and I know coaches say, hey, every point is big. But there are certain shots in basketball that just change the momentum of the game. And all the three-pointers by Montag have been big. The first one she made brought Garrigan back into the game if they were down 10. And that one just there may have been the proverbial dagger as Lake Mills having a hard time down 42-27 to look at that lead.
43 seconds left in the quarter. Vonick from the baseline lobs it up to the top of the key to Severson, who just checked in. 39 seconds left in the quarter. Now looking for the baseline, it's Sauer. Sauer throws it back up top to Vonick, just to the left of center. Kemna swatting at the basketball as Vonick gives it up back to Sauer. 30 seconds on the clock, 22 on the shot clock. Now it's an elbow jumper on the way. Way short as Bechtel can't knock it down. Offensive rebound, the putback no good, and Murphy rips the rebound away.
Oh, that'll pull your hair out if you're the Lake Mills coach. Two great-looking shots, neither of them went. Haven't been able to find a way for them to get Vonick back in the offense, though. Good defense by the Bears prevailing.
Lake Mills with just 4 points in this third quarter. 7 seconds left as Bishop Garrigan to take the last shot. Montag gives it off to Aulish. 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second for Murphy, and Bishop Garrigan is not going to get this one off. A little bit too unselfish for the basketball there, and Lake Mills did a nice job denying the three-point try. In any case, though, Bishop Garrigan heads to the fourth quarter up 42-27 on KLGA 92.7 and the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beich, Jason Brace, Daniel Folt, and Michael Toth.
Kemco Tires. They're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 Agency. A fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm Insurance Agent in Algona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
EMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Garrigan slowly pulling away from Lake Mills right now, 42-27 as we enter the fourth quarter. Over the past two quarters, Bishop Garrigan has outscored Lake Mills 35-11 to erase that early first quarter deficit. With the basketball, it'll be Lake Mills to start off the fourth as Vonick will run point. Vonick so far just 4 points tonight. Sauer of just 6 for Lake Mills, so Bishop Garrigan has done a nice job on those two guards. Severson goes across the court to Vonick on the wing, and we're rolling here in quarter number four. Lake Mills needs points, and they need them fairly quickly. Capacious tried to knock it away. Picking the basketball back up, though, is Bechtel. Bechtel pivoting in the corner, trying to avoid Capacious reaching for that ball. And the pass is thrown away. Eastman intercepted it in the post. Aulish runs the other way. Aulish dives down the lane, scoops the layup up, and she draws the foul. Vonick was in her path, and Sasha Aulish will shoot two.
Yeah, same move that she did before. She goes to the left-hand side of the hoop and then pirouettes, turns her back to the basket, and just tries to flip it up with her right hand. And it gets the foul call. Heads to the line to try to extend this 15-point lead.
Aulish swishes the first foul shot, 43-27, Bishop Garrigan.
Well, Tyler, with the new free throw rule that they have to get 5 fouls in a quarter, it seems like, even though it's the same game, the girls are fouling less, almost if they have this in the back of their head, that fouls are going to end up being a bad thing. And much less team fouls in the game so far this season.
I think it's been a good change so far as Aulish nearly knocks the pass away. Vonick steps in for a jumper just inside the free throw line as Eastman rebounds the miss. Alex to Bartolo, quick pass to Aulish, under the bucket, lays it up, and it pops in and out. Severson had the rebound briefly, and Aulish runs into her for a foul.
Oh, that is exactly the kind of tempo that the Bears want to run. It all went perfectly to plan except for the miss bucket at the end. But the Bears 2-3 has just locked down this Lake Mills offense. They just can't seem to penetrate, get anything in that lane. And good credit to Bartolo and Aulish up top. They have been a great job keeping any rhythm out of this picture.
That's been the great thing for Bishop Garrigan the past few years is a floater is in and out. Sauer can't knock it down. Bishop Garrigan can switch between the 2-3 zone and man-to-man defense depending on the matchup on the given night. They played a lot more man recently, but that zone is always in their back pocket as Eastman gets it deep in the post and lays it up and in.
She gets a rebound at one end, runs down to the other end, and gets a layup.
16 points by Eastman, 12 by Montag for Garrigan. As a three-point ball finally drops, Cora Sauer knocks it down, and that'll make it 46-30.
That might be Lake Mills' best bet. Their strength seems to be get the ball on the way to the hoop before Garrigan can set up that 2-3 like they did there.
Lake Mills, 24.5% on three-point tries this past season as Aulish tees up a deep three-point ball. That's a little bit too strong. Rolls over to Eastman, gets it out to Bartolo. She'll try right-angle three, in and out, no good. Capacious tips the rebound. She swats it out of bounds. And, yes, that was Capacious who touched it last as Lake Mills gets it back.
You know, I was just watching that, and both Capacious and Eastman had the Lake Mills players had great position on both Capacious and Eastman, but they just kept leaping and trying to tip it and battle. And I almost got that rebound back to the Bears, but good box outs by Eastman, Capacious.
46-30, Lake Mills could use another free point ball right now as they trail by 16. Driving the baseline, it's Sauer. Sauer shoots through traffic, and it's blocked by Eastman. Quick outlet up to Aulish. Aulish runs the floor. She lays it up, and it pops in and out. No good. Rebound by Redig. Vonick did a nice job staying vertical and not fouling on that one. Quick pass the other way off the fingertips of Sauer, and it's out of bounds back to Garrigan.
Oh, that was a nice pass right down the lane, threaded the needle, but the Lake Mills player running the floor couldn't handle it. Both teams fast breaking now, coming up to the 5.5 minute mark.
Sasha Aulish, guarded by Cora Sauers. Aulish heads right around the perimeter, flings it over to Montag. Montag looking for Eastman inside. Instead, she'll pass it up to Capacious. Lobs it inside Eastman and missed the layup. Got her missed back. Shot blocked. And Lake Mills avoids a couple Bishop Garrigan chances as Bechtel got the ball. Now Vonick stops on the left wing. Gets it over to Sauer. Now back to Vonick. Lets the three rip and missed it a little bit left. Capacious outfights Dogstead for the rebound. Now Aulish, deep on the wing, three-point launch, and it's off the back of the cup. Long rebound out to Capacious, though, and she gets it quickly into Eastman. Eastman on the near side, flips it up to the right hand, and she draws the foul.
We've seen some deep threes by Garrigan so far this game. That one might have been a little too deep for Aulish. Of course, I'm saying that because she missed it. If that swishes, the student section goes crazy, and she looks like the next Caitlin Clark. So, Tyler, how much of that is the Caitlin Clark effect of these last couple years of high school girls basketball? Like, everyone wants to rain down the three balls, it seems.
I think it's been building. People, you know, a few years ago, they'd say they were imitating Steph Curry because he kind of revolutionized the three-point game. But, you know, Caitlin Clark has now done it in the women's game as well. So people copy what they see. So I do think the higher levels have some influence, at least, if subliminally.
Definitely an impact.
18 points now for Eastman, 48-30. She knocks down the two free throws. Ball loose in the lane. Jump ball forced by Bishop Garrigan. Possession arrow towards the Golden Bears.
You know, and the same thing goes for post play, but it's not as flashy. So Eastman, you know, has watched. She's just a freshman. She's clearly played a lot of basketball in the AAU circuit and whatnot. And she sees players like Crooks, you know, playing inside. She's in no hurry to shoot the three balls, but boy, these Garrigan guards, they want to shoot from long way.
Bartolo flips it into Eastman. Eastman off the window, and there's two more. 20 points by Eastman, and the Golden Bears have blown it open. 50-30 here in the fourth quarter. One thing that Coach Schwab didn't like in the first half of the Belmont-Columbia game, he said Eastman didn't demand the basketball enough. She is demanding the basketball right now. Golden Bears force another turnover. Bartolo runs the floor. Oh, the fake to Aulish in the layup as Bartolo is fouled. Couldn't get that one to fall, but a chance for two free throws here. Did a nice fake to Aulish, the sidestep in the attempted layup.
Yeah, just a very workmanlike performance by Eastman today. She's worked hard the whole game. She's been rewarded for it with nice passes from her guards, getting good position. You know, if you work hard as a post player and get position, that's where you want to be. You want to get that ball close to the basket. That's where highest percentage shots are, and that's where good things happen. And Eastman has earned every bit of it today. She is red, and she has been working hard and a well-earned day off of school tomorrow because it's an in-service.
Second free throw by Bartolo misses. She'll settle for a split of the pair as Bishop Garrigan leads 51-30. I'll tell you what, Beanie, unlike the past couple of years, there's really not a big avalanche for Bishop Garrigan scoring-wise, but both against Belmont-Clemmy and today against Lake Mills, the Golden Bears have just gradually pulled away and really not let the opposing team have a run to get back into it. Jumper on the way, and it's knocked down. Cora Sauer from mid-range, and she now has 11.
Yeah, and then this is ball control. If you get behind against the Bears, you are going to have a heck of a time creating turnovers to get back into it because they handle the ball so well.
Capacious into Eastman. Puts it up, and she'll draw another foul. Boy, Eastman is drawing a ton of fouls. This time, Emma Taft victimized, and Eastman will shoot two more as Lake Mills now has 14 fouls.
Yeah, Eastman also just seems to have a lot of fun out there playing basketball. You know, she's just enjoys the game, another farm kid. She doesn't mind the battle, and she's off to a great start here at Bishop Garrigan as a freshman.
First free throw no good by Eastman. 51-32 Golden Bears, a 3:58 left. Eastman's second one crawls up the front of the rim and drops through, and the Golden Bears have a 20-point lead once again. 21 points right now for Eastman, the game's leading scorer on either side. Golden Bears have done a nice job defensively on Vonick tonight, as she's been held to 4 points. Here's the high screen by Taft. Vonick with an elbow jumper, missed it right, and Capacious, we had another rebound. She's got to be in double digits. I don't have an official tally, but she has been a rebounding machine so far tonight.
She's got 84 rebounds, Tyler.
I'll just believe you on that. I'm not going to fact check it. Eastman again against Taft, and she'll draw another foul. Eastman works across the paint towards the right, and she'll shoot yet another two free throws. This is going to be a good formula for Bishop Garrigan of Eastman. Boy, I mean, she's a little bit stronger on the right side right now down on the post, but she just continues to be aggressive. She continues to call for the ball and continues to just draw a ton of fouls.
Yeah, she's got footwork, and she has a great sense of where the defender is positioned on her hips. She can feel where that person's at. She knows which way to turn. She's done a couple nice moves tonight where she's split two defenders and able to get that ball up to the hoop. I've just met her this year. It's her first year at Bishop Garrigan as a freshman. She's in biology class getting to know her, and she clearly has put in some time in the gym, I'll tell you that much.
54-32, Bishop Garrigan as Eastman knocks down two free throws. She has been great at the charity stripe tonight after coming in at just 50%. Lake Mills in the lane, Dagstead gets it back outside to Bonnick with 3:18 left in the ball game. Lake Mills has Mackenzie Budok in the ball game. Her three-point ball, no good. And now it's chased down by Aulish. Here comes the Bishop Garrigan sophomore heading towards the left. Finds Bartolo, open on the perimeter, lobs it into Eastman. Eastman catches, can't finish that one though. And Capacious steals another rebound, back up a bit, and it rolls off no good. And then a foul on the loose basketball against Bishop Garrigan.
Capacious with the aw shucks look as she knew she missed a bunny there. She went to get some points on the board. Capacious is the glue to this team. And she doesn't have to be the point scorer to be the glue to that team. Boy, everyone on that floor, Eastman especially as a freshman, just relies on the rock-steady leadership of Capacious out there. So she leaves the game here, probably not going to come back. She had three fouls and 3 points when she left. But like you said, Tyler, she's a force out there all night.
Alyssa Hoagland and Reese Kemna laughing at each other at the top of the two-free zone right now as Murphy's also in for Bishop Garrigan. Aulish, Eastman, Murphy, Kemna, and Hoagland for Bishop Garrigan. Corner pocket free ball sour, and it's a little bit too strong. Eastman for the rebound and gets it out quickly to Kemna.
Now that was the ball movement on offense by Lake Mills that they've been needing. It's just a little too late.
54-32, Bishop Garrigan, Golden Bears roaring towards 4-0. Another find of Eastman, another finish. That's Sasha Aulish dishing out the assist, and 25 points by Eastman.
She lulls everyone to sleep. She drives the lane, but instead of finishing with the layup, she just lobs it up with one hand. It kind of looks like a shot right to Eastman.
Foul line jumper, no good on the turnaround by Sauer. Eastman knocks the basketball down, and a foul going against Lake Mills. One official said jump ball, one said foul. That might have been jump ball before the foul. As Montag will check in. Eastman's heading to the bench probably for the last time as she'll wrap up her evening of 25 points. A new career high for the Bishop Garrigan freshman.
Boy, she got a good workout tonight. A lot of minutes, a lot of hard work in the paint.
Ball swatted away by Montag, out of bounds, last touched by Bishop Garrigan. A 2-8 left in this one. Bishop Garrigan face state championship rematch looming on Thursday night as they visit Newell Fonda. Lake Mills gets it into play of 2:07 left. That'll be a boys and girls match without a travel. Turnover by Budok, and the ball go back to Bishop Garrigan, just over 2 minutes left. But Aulish on that last bucket for Bishop Garrigan dished out an assist. She has 5 assists per game so far this season after averaging just over 2 last year. And Aulish will check out for the senior Elena Casey. So Golden Bears will dig into the bench here for the final 2:03. And they will get ready for Thursday with a 4-0 record and a top 10 ranking in the Girls Union Class 1A rankings. 1:57 left. Hoagland over to the right to Kemna. Kemna looking inside, now passes left to Montag with 1:52 left in this one. Montag almost blew a tire. She hands it off to Murphy, top of the key. Shot clock never started. They decided not to bother with that as Kemna holds it and gives it off to Hoagland. Hoagland drives left of the lane. She scoops it up and she rolls it in.
Oh, great touch. Defies the law of physics with that basket. Comes in at a horizontal angle and crawls up and over the rim. Nice play by Hoagland.
Under the bucket, Mullen draws a foul and she'll shoot 2 for Lake Mills. Past couple possessions, they've given up on running the shot clock here. That 35-second clock atop the scoreboard has stayed at 35, but they've scored quickly enough, or attempted shots quickly enough, as 2 free throws coming by Ava Moen.
Lake Mills is going to run the floor here. They got their starters, and they're going to try to put up some points here in the last minute and a half. Haley Nemers comes in for Zoe Montag. So Murphy's in there as the senior to hold it all together. Other than that, it's got a lot of the JV squad in there right now. Hoagland, of course, plays a lot of varsity minutes. Murphy with the rebound. Here come the Bears.
Bowen splits the pair as Bechtel checks in for Lake Mills. Lake Mills is missing the senior Bryn Rognes tonight. Had an ACL injury earlier in the year she was dealing with, but should be back at some point for Lake Mills and returning to the lineup as Casey tees up a free ball. It's short. Rebound Nemers. Nemers takes one dribble. Nemers back up with it, and she puts it in.
Nemers has such a great touch in the lane. She's not as tall as Eastman, but she's got a lot of experience at the post.
Ball underneath to Moen. Threads it to Bechtel. Bishop Garrigan now with four straight games to start the season to the 60-point mark as Kemna comes up with the steal. Golden Bears will have the basketball right now, up 60-33, and heading towards top of Iowa West win number 58 in a row, dating back to January 10th of 2020. That was also Bishop Garrigan's last home loss, January 10th of 2020, as the Golden Bears extend that streak as well. Kemna will draw the foul with 40 seconds left on the pass to Nemers. And that is number five against Lake Mills, so Kemna will set up for two free throws.
Elena Casey going to the line here. She's a senior on this basketball team. Elena Casey, just one of those kids, just committed to every program here at Garrigan, just puts in as much time as everyone else at Garrigan. And, she didn't get the bucket. And the crowd goes, a big collective groaned by the crowd because we just want to see Elena Casey score so much. The bench was ready to light it up. She worked so hard. Tyler, Elena Casey knows how to hit. She'd be good on the football team. She's been pounding Audie Crooks. She's been pounding Audie Crooks for years, her and Haley Nemmer. So they definitely know how to bang inside.
0-for-2 trip to the line by Casey. 35 seconds left in this one as Lake Mills will try to get a couple more points on the board before the time expires. Severson passes inside to Taft. Nemers stays vertical. Ball knocked out of bounds by Murphy from behind. 27.2 seconds left in this one.
So how strange, you know, we've got a lot of reserves in for Garrigan. Two seniors on the floor able to drive. So Bears are very deep.
Ball knocked out of bounds, 23.7 seconds left. And this is something you talked about a lot last year, Beanie. The sophomore class for Bishop Garrigan is so big. So many girls, sophomores playing basketball. That's really helped round out the bench. And there's a lot of sophomores who would be in the rotation for other teams in the top of Iowa West who are not in the rotation for Garrigan because of how deep they are.
Yeah, for sure. You're looking at this reserve five in for the Bears right now. A lot of teams would be really pleased to have them as their starters. And they are not giving any ground right now. Lake Mills can't score here.
Outside Bechtel, rainbows a three-point ball too long, and Casey grabs the rebound and puts it in her pocket with 8 seconds left. Hoagland will walk it across half court, and the final 5 seconds will take away. Bishop Garrigan puts another top of Iowa West win in the scorebook, and they will be 4-0 heading to Newell Fonda on Thursday night. Bring on the Mustangs, Beanie Bodie, as Bishop Garrigan wins this one tonight, 60-33 inside of their home gymnasium. We'll step aside for a timeout, wrap up the girls' game, and get ready for the guys' game coming up next on KLGA and at the Elgona Radio YouTube stream.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you gotta go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions. Satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op. Delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump It. They do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Albert Electric. Flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Grassmasters, growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments, quality apartments for rent, beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts, open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
A workmanlike performance by the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears tonight as they overcome an early 15-5 deficit to defeat the Lake Mills Bulldogs by a final count of 60-33. I'm Tyler Lance alongside Beanie Bodie here on KLGA and at the Elgona Radio YouTube stream. And the scoring by quarter looked like this. Lake Mills jumped out to a 15-7 lead after one, but Bishop Garrigan had a 21-7 scoring advantage in the second quarter, taking a 5-point lead into halftime. Golden Bears extended their lead in the third quarter with a 14-4 scoring edge as they went up 42-27 going to the fourth. And in the final quarter, Bishop Garrigan Garrigan outscored Lake Mills 18-6, taking this 60-33 victory. In total, over the final three quarters, Bishop Garrigan outscored Lake Mills 53-17 with a stifling defensive performance. Scoring-wise, Gracelyn Eastman had a career game, her highest point total of her young career of 25 points. Zoe Montag added 12 for Bishop Garrigan. On the Lake Mills side, Cora Sauer led the way with 11. Taylor Vonick was held to just 4 points. Beanie, I'll start with the defense. We obviously talk a lot about the offense as sports fans, but tonight, Golden Bears made the adjustment. They shifted to a 2-3 zone defense against Lake Mills, had a ton of success with that, and really limited a tremendous player in Taylor Vonick to just 4 points.
Yeah, Vonick, when she was out on the open floor in that first quarter, she was picking everyone apart. Lake Mills got some good buckets in the paint from that block spot. And then Coach Swab makes the change to the 2-3, and after that, they were never able to really get any good inside looks, and they weren't able to run the floor anymore. So the Bears kind of they approach each game, I suppose, differently. They say, should we press this team? Lake Mills, not a team that I think they were going to press real successfully against with good ball handling on the Lake Mills squad. So they just drop back in their 2-3 and put the emphasis on that, and it really worked.
No doubt about it, Beanie. And on the offensive side, we've seen a couple variations of this Golden Bear team. We've seen games where they've been hunting out three-point ball after three-point ball, and that worked in the first couple games. Today, they were hunting out post-touches for Gracelyn Eastman. Post-touch after post-touch, she drew a ton of fouls. She made most of her three throws. She got a fair share of buckets as well, and really a tremendous day by the guards, passing the ball to Eastman inside and continuing to look for the 5'11 freshman.
Yeah, like I said earlier in the broadcast, she definitely doesn't play like a freshman, both with her game and also her body language. Like, she's excited for her teammates when they score. They're excited for her. She plays with a ton of confidence for a freshman, so very impressive. She's going to be one of those players, much like Crooks, that when she's a senior, they're going to say, it seems like that girl's been here forever, because it looks like the top five of conference is going to have this post to reckon with. And then with Haley Nemers and Reagan Murphy right behind her to come in, the Bears are just picking up with that same offensive look. They are not afraid to go inside on you. And if you try to defend that, guess what? There's three-point shooters everywhere. So, boy, it's just a really tough team to defend of the Bishop Garrigan Bears. I like to think about it. You know, like, what would you do to defend the Bears when you have both inside and outside? You can't really key on anybody. I mean, it's a tough one. It's a puzzler.
It is a well-balanced Bishop Garrigan team that can win in a different way on a nightly basis. And right now, they are 4-0 on the season of the big road trip to number 2-ranked Newell Fonda coming up on Thursday night. So Bishop Garrigan wins this one. They are now 4-0 and a perfect 2-0 on top of Iowa West play. Lake Mills drops to 2-2 on the season, and they fall to 2-1 in the conference. Right now, we'll step aside for a timeout, and we'll start to get you ready for the boys' game. We've already heard from Bishop Garrigan boys assistant coach Tyler Tiffany during halftime of the girls' game, and we'll check in with Lake Mills head coach Kyle Menke. That's around the corner on KLGA 92.7 and the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
At Security State Bank, we focus on the needs of local families, businesses, and farmers. Decisions are made locally. We live and work in your neighborhood, helping to keep our local community vibrant and growing. We're involved in local community events. We believe in personalized service and advice that meets or exceeds your expectations. We're Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne. Bankers who believe in you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Security State
Bank. We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you gotta go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions, satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op, delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump It. They do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Albert Electric. Flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Grassmasters. Growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company. Certified public accountants. Where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments. Quality apartments for rent. Beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts. Open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Getting ready for boys high school basketball action right now on Hometown Radio KLGA as the Lake Mills Bulldogs visit the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. And right now we check in with Lake Mills head coach Kyle Mankey. Coach, we appreciate your time today heading into tonight's game, and obviously a good start for your team so far this season. 2-0 in the top of Iowa West with a couple of dominant wins so far. So could you just start off our listeners with an overview of what your thoughts are from those first two games?
Yeah, we've gotten off to a really good start. Our kids have come out with a lot of energy and excitement to begin the year. And we opened with a good home win against Belmont on Friday, and then followed that up with a solid road win at West Hancock. And we've got some nice experience back and working some new faces into it as well this year. And so we're excited about the upcoming season.
And, Coach, like you said, you do bring some experience back, 4 or 5 starters returning from last year. So what is the level of expectation around the program going into this season?
Well, you know, we want to continue our high level of play. We've had some very good success the last few seasons. And the kids this year know that it's a brand-new year and that they're going to have to earn everything that they get. And, you know, we're going to have a good tough test tonight here with Bishop Garrigan. And the kids are looking forward to the challenge.
And, Coach, one of those key players for you tonight is going to be Aiden Stensrud, because he's off to an unreal start so far this season, and not just for the amount of points he's scoring, but with how efficiently he's doing at nearly 85% shooting from the field. So can you just speak on how great he's been so far for you guys and the type of challenges you feel he presents to the opposition?
Well, you know, Aiden's a very versatile player. He handles the ball well, and, he's obviously a very, very tough interior scorer for us, and he's a hardworking kid. He's put a lot of time in the sport of basketball in the off season, and like you said, he's off to a tremendous start. Had 25 points against Belmont and 35 against West Hancock, and just a kid that spends a lot of time working at the game and is very skilled and talented. And we're hoping that he can have another excellent performance tonight against Bishop Garrigan.
And, Coach, talking about the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears, their team that does have some good pieces on the team, but is definitely a little bit on the younger side, too. So, just looking at them on film, what are a couple of things that jump out to you?
Well, I think they're going to be a much improved team. We've had some tough battles over here over the years, and we expect that again here tonight. And, two very talented young guards that present a lot of challenges they play at a quick pace, and they've got some size on the interior as well. So, we have a lot of respect for what they can do, and we're just hoping that we can execute our game plan and come out of here with a win.
Talking right now with Lake Mills head coach Kyle Mankey. And, Coach, those two young guards for Bishop Garrigan, Carter Schwab and Michael Joyce, definitely a key focus for the Bishop Garrigan offense. So how do you go about trying to limit their impact tonight?
Well, I think you got to stop them in transition first. I mean, they're a very good duo, pushing the pace and really attacking well in transition. So we'll hope to get back on defense and make them play in the half court, and then just really try to play solid defense on them and limit their easy looks. And whenever you're playing against good players, you just try to make them earn their points. And that's what we're going to try to do tonight with Schwab and Joyce.
Coach, as we wrap up for today, along those same lines, what do you feel is the biggest key for a Lake Mills victory?
Well, I think, I mentioned the transition defense. We're going to need to move the ball well offensively. They play a mix of man-to-man and then that 1-2-2 zone. And they do some nice things out of both. We're going to have to continue trying to build a versatile attack on off.
Coach, we appreciate your time today and wish you best of luck in tonight's game.
Yeah, thank you very much, Tyler.
That is Lake Mills head coach Kyle Mankey here on Hometown Radio KLGA. We'll step aside for a timeout and get you closer to tip-off of game number 2 of our basketball doubleheader coming up next.
We've got more Sports Club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, 2 sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Algona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle,
passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Algona and Armstrong, keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
SignWorks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Algona Tree Service.
Sports Club members bringing you this game.
At Security State Bank, we realize each customer has a unique set of needs and goals. That's why we place a greater value on providing outstanding customer service. All products and services are designed for customers within our local community. We value each customer that walks through our door and wants to give them the personalized attention they deserve. Find out why Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne is your partner in community banking. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Security State Bank.
Thank you to these sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Kossuth Regional Health Center, make KRHC your home for health care.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, carrying steel and Toro products and Green Mountain pellet grills.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Runke Brothers Full Service. Experience the Runke Brothers difference for all your auto service and repair needs.
Erpelding Boyd & Company CPAs. They're not just about taxes.
Hy-Vee. Use the Fuel Saver card. Fill your cart, fuel your car.
North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Algona, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Erpelding Excavating Enterprises. Let them take care of your grading, excavating, and drainage needs.
AK's Chrome Kitchen. When you come in, your family.
All sponsors of this game broadcast. We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Algona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle, passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Algona and Armstrong, keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
SignWorks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Algona Tree Service.
Sports Club members bringing you this game.
Big thanks to Lake Mills head coach Kyle Menke for giving me a few minutes of his time earlier today to record a pregame interview, as just heard his thoughts wrap up a few minutes ago. Right now we're getting set for basketball action. It's the Lake Mills Bulldogs coming off a 23-1 season last year and a 2-0 start to this season against the 1-1 Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. I'm Tyler Lance alongside Beanie Bodie. And Beanie Boy, and Bishop Garrigan and Lake Mills battle in the gym. It's always an interesting night. Now, the theme throughout the season is Garrigan, how quickly can they get into it coming off a football season? They're going to be tested for that tonight. They were tested this past Saturday against one of the best teams in the state in Western Christian. They're going to be tested against the 52 game in a row top of Iowa West winning streak Lake Mills Bulldogs in tonight's game.
Right, Lake Mills, year in and year out, great team, been to state several times over the last few years. And wow, they are going to come back as a good team again. Got a lot of returning faces. And like you said, Coach Menke, you've been doing this for a while. Nice interview there. They know what they're doing, and the Bears are not yet polished. So that is going to make for an interesting start to this game. To see how it all begins is going to really send a big broadcast for this game right here in the first 2 minutes. So buckle up, everyone, and pay attention to these first 2 minutes. I think it's going to be pretty exciting. Both these teams like to run. And like you said, Tyler, there's been some intense matchups by these teams recently. I remember one in this gym where it was as loud as I've heard it in here. And last year at Lake Mills, Garrigan was really close to knocking them off there before a big rally at the end by Lake Mills. And boy, it was intense over there. And Lake Mills, just really fun when these two teams get together.
This is a conference record, 52-game conference winning streak by Lake Mills. They had three close calls last year. One of them was against Bishop Garrigan, a 66-61 Lake Mills win in December. That was a game where Bishop Garrigan had a second-half double-digit lead, but it slipped away late. Lake Mills was also tested a couple times last year as they had a close game against North Union, a three-point win over the Warriors on February 7th, and a seven-point win over West Hancock on December 8th. So Lake Mills, they were a team that had a very different lineup last year, some new faces rotating in and out compared to previous years. This year, that's not the case. They have four of their five starters back, and they are led by Aiden Stensrud. Stensrud averaged a double-double last season, and so far this year, he has 60 points in two games. Bishop Garrigan's got to focus on that 6'5 junior. He's the only junior in Lake Mills starting lineup, but he is a major threat to make a big impact in tonight's game. Lake Mills getting introduced on the floor right now, head coach Kyle Menke, Bishop Garrigan with coach Mark Meister. As they introduce the lineups, we'll step aside for one final timeout and come back after this on KLGA 92.7.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with Money Pass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the Money Pass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue Money Pass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at moneypass.com. Money Pass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
One moment away from basketball action here on KLGA 92.7 and at the Algona Radio YouTube stream. Looking at tonight's starting lineup for this Tom Fly West battle for the Lake Mills Bulldogs under head coach Kyle Menke. That'll be four seniors and one junior. The 5'11 senior Alex Manis, the 6'2 senior Logan Bacon, the 6'5 senior Eli Menke, the 6'5 senior Lance Helming, and the 6'5 junior Aiden Stensrud. For the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears under coaches Meister and Freilich, they will have the 6' tall freshman Michael Joyce, the 6' senior Justin Bauer, the 6'4 junior Drew Mahler, the 6'3 sophomore Carter Schwab, and the 6'5 senior Logan Nemers. Golden Bears wearing their white home uniforms, the gold lettering and numbering on the front and back. Lake Mills in the road purples. They have the white numbering and lettering outlined in yellow, and the checkerboard design in white and purple down the side of their jersey. So 8 minutes of basketball action on the clock here in quarter number one. Lake Mills Bulldogs and the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. Lake Mills has dominated the series as of late as far as the win column is concerned, as they have beaten Bishop Garrigan eight consecutive times. There have been a couple close ones in there, but they have had the edge on Golden Bears over the past couple of seasons. Golden Bears, their last win against Lake Mills came on December 10th of 2019, so they'll look to snap that losing streak tonight. And again, Lake Mills with a 52-game top of Iowa West win streak on the line in tonight's matchup. Logan Nemers heads the center court. The 6'5 senior for Bishop Garrigan wipes off his shoes and gets the traction. He will go up against Aiden Stensrud, the 6'5 junior. Stensrud leading Lake Mills with 60 points through two games. He was a first-team all-conference selection last year.
Okay, a lot of size out on the floor. Muller big, Nemers big, Schwab big. Those guys are all on the offensive line for Garrigan. Lake Mills right back at you. A lot of size on that side.
Ball's in the air. Nemers wins the tip, and his top of Iowa West battle is underway as Bishop Garrigan heads left to right on the radio dial to start the game. Bauer wearing that knee brace on his left leg, passes to Nemers. Nemers finds the cutting Joyce. Ball stripped, but a foul on Lake Mills. Their first foul of the game as Bishop Garrigan opens with a drive by the young freshman.
Yeah, real quick call there. Manis picks up an early foul. Joyce lightning quick to the basket, and Manis tried to slap the ball away. Hurt his wing a little bit. He's doing some windmills with that right wing of his. Might have tweaked his shoulder a bit.
Michael Joyce had 23 points against Western Christian on Saturday out of the 50 scored by Bishop Garrigan, so nearly half the Golden Bear point total in that career-high effort as he hits the first free throw. Manis for Lake Mills appeared in all 24 games last season off the bench. He was the only Lake Mills reserve to play in every game, and now he's in the starting lineup as Joyce's second free throw rims out and Stensrud tracks down the rebound. Running point for Lake Mills, it'll be the 6'2 senior Logan Bacon, the all-conference honorable mention from last season. Dribbles the left hand as Bauer guards near half court. Stensrud back to Bacon on the wing. 1-0 Bishop Garrigan. Lake Mills led the conference with 71.8 points per game last season. Lance Helming working against Schwab, driving in, draws the foul, he put it in. Chance for a three-point play by Lance Helming.
Wow, big strong move by Helming. He kind of bounces off Schwab, falls out of bounds and backwards from the hoop, and still is able to use the glass and kiss it into the hoop. Put the Lake Mills Bulldogs on the board. Short-lived lead for Garrigan, 2-1 Bulldogs.
Big boy move by Lance Helming, who averaged 17.7 points per game last year. Missed the free throw, rebound Menke in the paint, and Lake Mills with a fresh 35. Well, that was Bacon in the paint as Menke drives in and lays it in for two.
4-1 Lake Mills. They turn that into a 4-point possession, essentially, and Bishop Garrigan finds themselves down by three.
Yeah, and rebounding. Stensrud, Helming, all of them. Bacon, boy, they just really are so good at crashing the board.
Backdoor cut, Michael Joyce, and he missed on the layup. Rebound by Lance Helming. It was a good pass by Bauer, and now Lake Mills quickly the other way. Mankey along the baseline, banging with Mahler, gets it back outside beyond the perimeter. Manis drives against Joyce, gets turned back out, and gives it off to Stensrud. Left side, Eli Mankey, 6:51 on the clock, and 4-1, Lake Mills on top of Bishop Garrigan. Lake Mills beat their opponents last year by an average of 24.4 points per game, and they'll turn it over here for travel.
Hey, that was good defense by Bears, really communicating. Kept that early drive from Manis from going anywhere to the lane, made Lake Mills keep trying to reset their offense, ended up getting a travel call on them. Good stand for the Bears.
4-1 Lake Mills. Bishop Garrigan has Schwab bouncing it over to right to Bauer. Bauer leading the team with assists so far as he has 12 assists. He's also made 5 of 7 shots as it's poked away by Mankey. Now Schwab has it. Nemer sets a screen. Schwab heads towards the student section, falls down and loses the basketball. Stensrud has it. Lob up to Mankey, making it under the bucket, goes crashing to the ground and can't knock the layup down. They'll let them play. Up ahead to Schwab as Garrigan has the basketball. Into Nemers. Nemers off the window, too strong, and the rebound again by Stensrud. Lake Mills with some pace the other way. It's Logan Bacon handing it off to Lance Helming. Right back to Bacon. Helming top of the key against Schwab. Spins towards the left. Fakes the pass. Fades back for the jumper. And he buries it. Beautiful shot by Lance Helming.
Yeah, he set that up with a really nice ball fake where he faked he was going to pass it down low. Froze the defense. Spin move and put it in. He's clearly got a lot of work done on those post moves. Got a couple brothers that I'm sure he's worked a lot of one-on-one with over the years.
Yes, Wyatt Helming is the name people will be familiar with as Joyce launches the three. It pops out of the cup, no good. Mahler sailed in but couldn't grab the rebound as Mankey comes out of it. Mankey was a second-team all-conference selection last year. Helming a first-team selection as Mankey launches the three and misses it off glass to the right. Now Schwab with pace the other way. Schwab scored 18 against Belmont Clemmie, Garrigan's leading scorer in the opener. Nemers, an elbow jumper, and he swishes it.
Yeah, for a big man that played center for the offensive line, he has one heck of a touch on his jump shot.
Nemers came into tonight 9 of 12 from the field, so make him 10 of 13 shooting on the young season. Most of it from in the paint, but that one a nice jumper as Helming banks it off the glass on the drive, and he scores again. Lance Helming, a great start.
Yeah, so far no answer by the Bears in any way to stop Helming here. Even before Wyatt Helming, his older brother, there was another Billy Goat Gruff there, Tyler. His name was Chet Helming, and they've all been fantastic ball players.
Joyce drives baseline, deals near side to Schwab. Catches, fires, drills a three-pointer.
And there's a good one. Carter Schwab, boy, he can shoot, handle the ball, he can do it all. Get him going.
Lake Mills works with Mankey the other way, drives baseline, bangs with Mahler, and Mahler will pick up the foul. Number two against Bishop Garrigan. As Mankey aggressively attacks the basket that time. That's the thing with Mankey. He's a big-time three-point shooter. You have to respect that, but if he tries to drive, you've got to be aware of that as well. So he kind of brings that multi-talented threat.
Yeah, that sure is. As much fun as it is watching these Garrigan players switch from football to basketball, this Lake Mills team is fun because we've gotten to know them well. These guys have been playing together for so long.
Mankey driving it again, challenges Nemers and draws the foul.
There's one right there. Mankey coming in as a senior now. Eli Mankey, I remember him as a freshman launching threes, and now he grew up. He's about a foot taller and much stronger. Now he's taking people to the hoop like he did just there. Gets himself to the free throw line.
Well, if you look at Mankey's stats, last year, 83% of his field goal attempts came from three-point range, so you're not used to seeing a ton of drives as he left that one short on the foul shot. He's a 42.5% three-point shooter, but he's attacked at the basket so far as he'll try to split the pair. Bishop Garrigan a three team fouls with 4:37 on the clock. Mankey again drops the second one in, and Lake Mills goes up by three at 9-6. Schwab will walk this one across half court. Golden Bears last year were the number two scoring offense in the conference behind Lake Mills at 66 points a game. Joyce screens for Schwab. Now Joyce gets it in the high post. Joyce wants to drive in, and he'll draw a foul. A lot of early fouls in this game, as that'll be number two against Lake Mills.
That one is on the floor. Joyce showing the ability to split defenders and get to the hoop, much like his older sister, Molly Joyce. She had a knack for finding that basket no matter where she was. Michael, the freshman, has got that same instinct.
Manis picked up foul number two, so Chase Gatsky will check into the ballgame for Lake Mills, the 6'1" senior. Senior-laden Lake Mills team, they have 4 of their 5 starters back from last year. They did graduate top of Iowa West Player of the Year, Denton Kingland, but a ton of talent back as Sink is in right now for Bishop Garrigan. Trayton Sink passing to Joyce up top. Now to the right to Bauer. Bauer feeds Nemers in the post. Pump fakes, puts it up, and he puts it in.
Yeah, if they can feed Logan Nemers in the paint more, that's going to be good for the Bears. He can clear out space, and he can get some easy buckets.
Nemers one-on-one of Stensrud that time as Bacon tees up a three-point ball and missed it right. Rebound pops loose and Helming off of the board. Missed off glass. Rebound Stensrud goes crashing to the ground, and another foul called. Number four against Bishop Garrigan as Coach Meister less than enthused on the sideline right now.
What a good battle in there for the rebound, both teams. I mean, Bacon, Stensrud, Nemers, Schwab, these are all big bodies, and they are battling there for the boards. Nemers is going to have to take a seat. Amari Thomas comes in the game.
Two fouls by Logan Nemers, so the sophomore Amari Thomas checks into the ball game. Thomas leading the team with 18 rebounds and 11 on the offensive glass as he'll guard Stensrud. From the baseline, Bacon running out of time, and that's a five-second call.
Nice defense by the Bears. You don't see the Bears force a lot of five-second calls. Well done, Bishop Garrigan, moving the feet, keeping anyone from getting open. You know, that's a timely foul that puts Nemers on the bench because he was just starting to feel it offensively, and the Bears were realizing that. But they don't lose a lot of ground. Thomas in there running the high post with
Bauer near side of the court. Bauer picks up his dribble, bounces it to Thomas. Thomas into the lane, and his shot is rejected by Stensrud. Thomas got it back, blocked again by Stensrud. Ball picked up by Getzky for Lake Mills. Great defensive sequence by Lake Mills as now Helming has it. Helming against Sink, spins towards the paint. Thomas the help defense. Helming misses the layup, and Sink snatches the rebound out of the air. Much better defense that time by the Golden Bears as Schwab sails in. Left-handed floater, no good. Helming had the rebound, and he got it over to Bacon. Golden Bears go one and done on that possession as Helming comes with the court. Cross-court feed to Mankey. Mankey, three-point try off the front of the rim, and Thomas grabs the rebound. Joyce the other way for Bishop Garrigan. The freshman has it up near half court as he's shadowed by Logan Bacon. Pass to the left to Bauer on the wing. Bounce pass into the post to Schwab. Back to the bucket against Helming. Schwab underhands it out to Bauer beyond the perimeter again. Lake Mills 9, Bishop Garrigan 8. 3 minutes left in quarter number one. Bauer driving, dishing to Sink. Near side of the court in the short corner. Now Schwab on the wing. Lets the three-pointer rip and left it short. Joyce sailed in to try to get the rebound, and it comes out to Bauer. Offensive board for Bishop Garrigan and a fresh 35. Now Schwab back to the bucket against Mankey. Heads to the foul line and underheads it back outside to Joyce. Not a lot open inside yet. Schwab sets the screen. He rolls off of it. Gets the pass from Joyce. Schwab left of the lane. Hits the spin move. Lost the ball, but he got fouled. Foul by Lance Helming for Lake Mills. That's their third team foul.
Well, that was some good time run off the clock by Bishop Garrigan. It's a one-point game. No reason to let this thing get helter-skelter right now. Joyce and Schwab, great teamwork up there at the top of the key. Those two young men working well together.
And Bishop Garrigan sophomore Tate Furch checks in. Missed the season opening game, but did have 7 points against Western Christian in that 75-50 loss on Saturday. Sink gives it off to Joyce. Offensive foul, Bishop Garrigan.
Yeah, Furch went to put a screen, and they weren't close enough together. The bodies weren't close enough together, and Furch had to lean a little bit to execute the screen. Moving screen is called. Good call. Furch playing with a big padded sleeve there, especially on his elbow. You know, Tyler, last week, beginning of last week, he got a piece of metal the length of his forearm removed, brought it to school, and had a little bit of show and tell.
Oh, man, what a treat for everyone in his class as the ball was knocked out of bounds. Lake Mills will keep it of 2:10 on the clock.
It is really impressive, like his recovery. If you don't know, he injured his arm so badly in baseball, a fracture you don't even want to talk about, and a modern medical miracle that kid even played in the state football championship game.
Yeah, that track season, got injured in the hurdles and missed most of the baseball season until the final couple of games as Bishop Garrigan forces the turnover. Schwab has the ball right now. Right to Sink. Now Furch open for a short corner jumper, left it short, and Mankey races in for the board. Bacon to bring it across half court. Averaged 5 assists per game last year for Lake Mills. Picks up his dribble near half court. Furch pestering him and trying to pivot away is Bacon and gets it all the way to Mankey in the far corner. Now back up top to Bacon. 20 on the shot clock. Back to Mankey in the corner. In the post, Stensrud turns into the center of the lane and puts the left-hander in.
Well, that was solid defense by the Bears. Lake Mills just executing that nicely.
Stensrud gives Lake Mills an 11-8 advantage right now. A Sink has it near side of the court. Off top to Joyce. Joyce heads left. Two dribbles and gives it to Schwab. Schwab driving in. Schwab bangs a Stensrud and draws the foul. Two free throws coming up for the Bishop Garrigan sophomore.
You know, that's what Schwab can do is create off the dribble, and he can get some people in foul trouble as this game wears on. No foul trouble for anyone yet, of course, but that is something to keep an eye on later in the game, as both these teams are going to keep ratcheting up the physical play. Whenever someone tries to drive to the hoop, you better expect to get hammered.
Kane Cook getting set to check in for Lake Mills, the 5'9" junior, after this first free throw by Schwab. Schwab averaged 10.8 points per game last year, missed on the first foul shot, and we stay at 11-8. Getzky heads to the bench as Cook checks in. So Schwab will try to split the pair. It's 11-8 Lake Mills, quarter number one. Lake Mills with 8 straight wins against Bishop Garrigan in this rivalry as Schwab drains the second foul shot, and it's back down to a 2-point game at 11-9.
When you have a rivalry like this, it's always fun to watch the JV game as well, see what the future holds.
The JV game went into overtime, so it was a hard-fought contest between these two in that one. Helming against Thomas, fades back for a jumper, rolls off the rim, rebounds Stensrud. The follow no good. Joyce had it briefly, and Thomas chases down the loose ball, and ball got tipped out of bounds. It wasn't touched by Garrigan, and it was. Schwab had a chance to get it. He let it go because he fought like Mills touched it, and Coach Meister is pointing and saying that should be Garrigan's ball, as the referees will confer.
Schwab is proclaiming that someone tipped it, but even, you know, no one saw it if it happened. So, again, once a call is made, umpires do not like to switch that call.
So Stendrud will inbound for Lake Mills. 53 seconds left in the first quarter as he gets it into the backcourt to Bacon. Bacon passes over to the right to Cook. Cook picks up his dribble. Cross-court feed over to Mankey. Bullets it inside Stensrud. He's open and he lays it in. 13-9 Lake Mills. Stensrud averaged 12.4 points per game last season on just under 63% shooting. It takes a lot of those high percentage paint shots. Bishop Garrigan down by four. Joyce waits for the play to develop. Finds Schwab along the perimeter. Schwab stops for an elbow jumper. That one got tipped, and the rebound is taken by Stensrud again. Stensrud already piling up the boards in this ballgame as Cook has Joyce fly by, steps into a long two with the foot on the line, pops out of the cup, no good. Stensrud another rebound. He's in traffic, puts it up, and it sits on the rim and drops off. Stensrud rips it away from Thomas, and a foul against Thomas. Look at Stensrud scrapping underneath the basket and getting Lake Mills extra possessions.
Boy, he was battling for that rebound. Him and Thomas both had a handle on it. They came down with the ball together, but Stensrud, like a wrestler, stepped inside the hips. Like he was going to do a throw, and that put Amari Thomas out of position.
Stensrud will get two free throws as Bishop Garrigan in the penalty right now. Stensrud 52.6% from the line. His stats so far this season have been insane. We said 60 points. He's done it on 27 of 32 shooting. That's just under 84.5% as he knocks down the free throw. 14-9 Lake Mills. Bauer comes in. Schwab checks out for the final 10.2 seconds of the quarter. Lake Mills drops Cook and Mankey back on defense to prevent a runout quickly by Bishop Garrigan. Stensrud good on the second free throw. 15-9 Lake Mills. Furch handles the rock with 7 seconds. Furch finds Joyce. Joyce wants to drive. Joyce attacks, dumps it to Thomas, and draws the foul. 3.6 seconds left, and that's a mistake by Lake Mills because that's foul number five.
Yeah, Joyce will get to go shoot two free throws in the rules. Five fouls will get you two shots at the free throw line.
So Joyce setting up for two more free throws, has 1 point so far today as he scored the first point of the game for Garrigan. Joyce drops that one in and makes it 15-10. You know, we talked about the long line of Helmings in the Lake Mills program. How about the long line of Joyce's in the Garrigan program, boys and girls?
Yeah, no kidding. Yeah, Molly graduated last year off to Truman State, do some great things, and her freshman younger brother gives us another 4 years to watch, as he is no doubt going to be playing the point guard spot this season.
And you previously had John Joyce on the Bishop Garrigan boys basketball team, a team that went to Wells Fargo Arena. Helming with 3.6 seconds left, rises for a three-point ball at the horn, and he left it short, as that will be the end of the first quarter. It's Lake Mills 15 and Bishop Garrigan 11 as we head to the second on KLGA 92.7 and at the Algona Radio YouTube channel.
Lake Mills 15, Bishop Garrigan 11.
At Security State Bank, we focus on the needs of local families, businesses, and farmers. Decisions are made locally. We live and work in your neighborhood, helping to keep our local community vibrant and growing. We're involved in local community events. We believe in personalized service and advice that meets or exceeds your expectations. We're Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne. Bankers who believe in you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Security State Bank.
For over 40 years, Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons have maintained one mission: to provide excellence in orthopedic care. Their team of 9 physicians offer specialized care in everything from arthroscopic same-day surgery to joint replacement, as well as hand and foot surgery, and have an orthopedic surgeon on call 24/7. Healthcare isn't about appointments. It's about taking care of people, and that's their specialty. Visit Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons on the web at nwiabone.com.
Start of the second quarter on Hometown Radio KLGA's. Lake Mills leads Bishop Garrigan 15-11. Beanie the key for Lake Mills in that first quarter. A big-time rebounding effort.
Yeah, boy, Stendrud is tough inside. Boy, he really has a nose for the rebound, knows how to position his body. He battles.
A sophomore, Nash Delger, running point for Lake Mills as he hands it off to Eli Mankey. Lake Mills going a little deeper on the bench now of Keaton Wempen as well. Helming against Schwab, trying to shield Schwab off, and Schwab bumps into his back and draws the foul. That'll be against Schwab, his second foul.
Yeah, two big guys bouncing off each other, but the officials say, well, we're going to call this right away. Keep this from getting aggressive between Schwab and Helming there. Lake Mills looks to inbound.
Delger gets it into Mankey on the wing, guarded by Schwab this time. Mankey drives into the paint, hangs, left it short. The cleanup by Stendrud again in the lay-in.
Boy, those rebounds by Stendrud. Very smooth. Nick Lear into the game. Yeah, tall junior for Bishop Garrigan.
Lear at 6'5" for the Golden Bears. Bishop Garrigan had a big rebounding edge against Belmont Clemmy, 46-30, but they lost the rebounding against Western Christian, 35-26. Joyce shoots a one-footed jumper. No good. Lear had the rebound briefly, but it's taken by Delger. Delger, long pass up the court. Finds Helming along the baseline. Pump fakes on the pass. Heads into the lane. Shoots the right-handed hook. Pops in and out. And Lear picks the rebound out of the sky.
There's got Lear in the game. Right away shows a battle on the defensive end. Gets a rebound. He almost had an offensive board a second ago.
Schwab guarded by Helming, a physical defense outside the three-point perimeter. 1 minute gone in the second quarter as Lake Mills leads 17-11. Bauer passes to Joyce, fades back for a jumper, and it jumps on the rim and drops in.
A super quick release by Joyce. Jumped and shot at the same time and turned in the air.
17-13, Lake Mills. Delger spins towards the right, drifts right of the lane. Good defense by the Bears. A find to Stensrud, though. Stensrud left of the bucket, puts it up over Lear. No, the tip, though, is up and good. Stensrud fixes his own miss, and it's 19-13.
Schwab's going to walk the ball up the top. Helming continues to guard him up top. Schwab's got good ball handling ability. Might try to take him to the hoop with Helming guarding him.
And ball is off a foot and out of bounds. It will stay Bishop Garrigan. I'll tell you what, Lake Mills is making almost no effort tonight to shoot threes. They're taking the ball inside and taking it inside with authority as Mankey checks out of the ball game for Lake Mills.
Yeah, and they're very well meshed as a team. They really know where the teammates are going to be. Good passes, right on the money, good cuts.
Bauer just to the right of center, finds Mahler in the lane. Ball got stripped away, but Mahler picks it back up. Back out to the top of the key to Schwab with 6:12 on the clock. The Bishop Garrigan sophomore dribbled it off his leg and picks it back up. Now Lear working in the paint. Lear's shot blocked by Stensrud. Boy, Stensrud is controlling this game so far for Lake Mills, and here he comes. Threads the pass to Helming, and there's two.
Oh, what a pass, boy. Three blocks so far for Stensrud, and then he runs the floor like a point guard there. Nice pass, threading the needle. Timeout on the floor. Bishop Garrigan wants to talk this over.
Timeout is called by the Golden Bears, down 21-13 with 5:51 on the clock in the second quarter, as we will keep it right here. But boy, I'll tell you what, Stensrud, he does a little bit of everything. We talked about his rebounding and scoring, but averaged 2 assists per game last season. Beautiful find on that last play. Lake Mills getting into transition and really operating well out of that.
Yeah, and that timeout might be just to stop that. Don't want to see Lake Mills get the transition game going. You know, just like they use it in volleyball when they need to break serve or something, just slow this momentum down. Don't want to get this Lake Mills team running the floor. Good timeout by the coaches here. Let's reassess what happened there at the start of the second quarter. Down 21-13 all of a sudden, and you don't want it to stretch out any further than this.
Lake Mills has been dominant in their two games so far this season as they beat Belmont Clemmy 93-44 and West Hancock 75-36. Really not a whole lot to complain about for them for the first two games. As Lake Mills, their team that had gone to state 3 years in a row in Class 1A. Last year they moved it to 2A, and that streak was broken. They made it to the sub-state game, but lost to MFL Marmac in that one. But now Lake Mills brings 4 of the 5 starters back from that team.
Yeah, and they've got a lot of success going over there. They had a very good football season. You know, they ran into, of course, those tough teams. St. Ansgar, West Hancock are juggernauts over in that area. But until they ran into those big boys, Lake Mills really put it together this year. You know, Bacon out there on the floor, younger brother Caleb Bacon, I'm sure, playing for the Cyclones. And, yeah, there's a lot of athletic talent.
right. Cyclones getting ready for a bowl matchup with Memphis in late December. As Bauer has the basketball, feeds Joyce. Joyce behind the defense, and he draws the foul. Deldrew, the guilty party. First team foul for Lake Mills in this quarter.
Nice lob pass into Joyce. Drew the foul, but had they not fouled, he would have had a good look at the basket. Bears clearly recognize Joyce has the ability to score against this lineup.
Schwab to set things in motion from the baseline. Schwab looks. No one coming open. Schwab lobs it into this tall Nick Lierba on the perimeter, guarded by Stensrud. Right back to Schwab. Back to the bucket as he plays in front of Lake Mills bench. And he'll back it up near half court. Creeping out to defend him right now. For Lake Mills, Logan Bacon. Schwab bounce pass to the right to Bauer. Bauer takes one dribble and picks it up. He tries to thread the needle to Joyce. He finds him. Joyce puts it up, and it's off the front of the cup. No good. Mahler tips the rebound away. That's out of bounds. Possession towards Lake Mills. That was an incredible pass by Bauer, even though it did not result in the bucket.
I was just going to say that, Tyler. I don't know if we've seen many passes that perfect. I can't believe he threw it. He absolutely had no other place to put that ball. Unbelievable pass by Justin Bauer there. Put it right on the bounce pass across the lane to a cutting Joyce.
Still 21-13 in favor of Lake Mills right now. In the high post, it's Hellman looking for Mankey on the give and go. Hellman keeps it instead. Shot rejected. Mahler got a hand on it. Throws it off the back of Lear, though. He didn't see the ball coming, and Lake Mills gets it back. In the corner, Mankey bobbles with it. He drives baseline. Mankey tries to wrap the pass around, and he'll draw a Bishop Garrigan foul instead.
Yeah, Lear is going to pick up the foul. Stay strong in there. Just keep playing. You know that. Rebound by Mahler was, or a block shot by Mahler, and he got so excited, thought Garrigan finally had a fast break. Neither team's really been able to get out and run, but they turned the ball over.
Bacon lobs it in, and Lear knocks it away briefly from Stensrud. Stensrud finds Helming on the wing, spins across the foul line, gets the bucket and lays it in. What a move by Lance Helming.
Yeah, pretty footwork spinning through the lane. Here comes the Bears.
Bauer the other way, goes crashing in, draws the foul, put it in, and a chance for a three-point play. Stensrud says, I stayed vertical. The referee said, nope, that's a foul.
Yeah, great aggressive run in the floor. Justin Bauer, the senior, he's got some great speed, beats everyone up the floor. That is Garrigan's game. If they can get that going, but neither team able to get the fast break going. And Mueller's going to check out. Nemers hasn't been in for a while because he's got two fouls. So Nemers back in the game. He's been very good offensively. Bears down eight right now. Bauer trying to creep back in with a free throw.
23-15. Bauer trying to finish the three-point play, and he does just that. Much needed play by Bishop Garrigan, and the score now 23-16. Lake Mills has Mankey wide open, lets it fly and swishes it. Garrigan lost Eli Mankey.
Just going to say that neither team has been able to get any good open looks from deep, and that time Mankey wide open, and the Bears just threw a lob pass over the head of everybody out of bounds, right back to Lake Mills, up 10 points, and here they come.
Mankey scored just over 12 points per game last year, most of that coming off the three-point ball, and he can get automatic sometimes when he heats it up. Had a couple big shots last year when these teams met in December to really help Lake Mills rally to defeat Bishop Garrigan 66-61. The other game went in favor of Lake Mills as well, 74-47. Down on the baseline, it's Helming near side. Back to the bucket. Finds the cutting Stensrud at the foul line. Underhands it out to Deldrew. Wide open free try. Off the back of the cup, no good. And here comes Schwab. Schwab with a little push. Schwab drifts toward the near side as Deldrew tries to knock the ball away. Now Schwab forced back to the middle. Gives it off to Joyce. Joyce to Lear beyond the perimeter. Lake Mills does a nice job preventing the transition opportunity for the Golden Bears. Nemers sets the screen, top of the key. He rolls off it. Gets the basketball, trying to find Lear. Knocked away by Lake Mills again. And here comes Eli Mankey. Mankey picked up by Bauer in defense, throws it into the backcourt. Bauer trying to chase that one down. Helming grabs it, but that's an over and back.
Boy, now the teams are starting to pick up the tempo a little bit.
Tempo is starting to turn up, as you said. Bishop Garrigan, they're a team that does want to play fast. A lot of young players on the team, but a lot of good athletes.
Well, Bear coaches made a good adjustment defensively. They realize they got to double team Helming when he gets the ball, and they'll take their risk with the outside shots.
Joyce in the post against Deldrew. Fades back for a one-legged jumper and knocks it down.
Well, that was pretty mismatch there. Joyce taking Dellinger, no problem. And Lake Mills throws it away, and Bears get it right back.
Logan Bacon threw it behind the head of Eli Mankey, who was not looking for the basketball. And Lake Mills will take a 30-second timeout, their first timeout called the game. But 26-18 right now. I want to highlight Michael Joyce, Beanie, because he's taken a couple tough shots. That time, he was posting up against the smaller player, the 5'7 Deldrew, and faded back for a beautiful jumper. He's shot that fadeaway a couple times coming out of that move.
Yeah, he hasn't had any easy shots except the free throw to start off the game. And since then, Joyce has been working so hard for every shot. They've tried to run a few set plays for him going back door. He's such a good young athlete. He's got speed. He's got incredible leaping ability. He's already kept a few rebounds alive just by his ability to get up off that floor. So he is a game changer, and the Bears are trying to use him as such. But, you know, Lake Mills calls this timeout because they were not happy there with that sloppy pass. Like, you can't just give away possessions to a team. And Garrigan looks to take advantage right now.
Lake Mills turns the ball over only 9.6 times per game last season. The best ball security team in the conference as Joyce floats from the lane and scores again.
Boy, he's got such a quick release. Dan Marino with a jump shot. Hardly hits the ball, get the fingers before it's up on the way to the hoop.
9 points by Michael Joyce, and Garrigan trying to crawl back into it, down 26-20. In the high post, Stensrud against Nemers. Heads right, dishes out to Delger. Delger driving in along the baseline. Bounce pass into the corner to Bacon. Back inside, Helming fades away. Missed it wildly off to the right. Ball knocked out of bounds, and who touched it last? Stensrud touched it last.
Yeah, Nemers had good position, and Stensrud tried to fight through the big man. Got a hand on the ball, knocked out of bounds. Joyce inbounds it to Schwab. They're only down six. Bears looking for a big possession here. Two would be nice, but I'm sure they're thinking three.
Final 2:50 before halftime. 26-20, Bishop Garrigan trailing Lake Mills right now as Bauer stops the elbow, continues his dribble and heads right around the lane. Poked away by Delger and he steals it, stays in bounds and he finds Mankey. Nice defensive play by the young sophomore stealing it right out from underneath Bauer. As now Mankey has it along the perimeter, starts to drive in, dishes to Delger, one-handed catch in the corner and goes right back to Mankey. 2:28 left, Joyce jumps a pass and he steals it and he steps out of bounds. Joyce nearly had a run out that time, but he'll force an inbounds play by Lake Mills.
Yeah, he slams the ball, power dribbles. He's upset, he knew he had a run out layup, would have cut it to 4 points. Now Lake Mills gets a fresh shot clock. 2:25 left to go until halftime.
Tate Furch checks into the ballgame for Bishop Garrigan. Furch, Joyce, Schwab, Nemers, and Lear right now as Delger steps into a right wing three-pointer, and he drains it.
And they were giving that to him. They weren't going to let it go to Helming inside. They took the chance, and he made him pay.
29-20, Lake Mills, and now Lance Helming engulfs the basketball on the other end off the Schwab drive. Here come the Bulldogs. In the corner, Delger lets it fly again. Good again! 32-20 is Nash Delger heating it up off the bench. Exactly what Lake Mills needed, and they're up by 12 at the snap of a finger.
You bet. Boy, it was 6 points just a second ago. 2 3-pointers reverse it. That three-point shot can really change the game, and that is a charge call.
Away from the ball against Bishop Garrigan, yeah. Their third team foul. That's going to go against Lear, his second.
Yeah, Lear just trying to get position. And he is tall, but, you know, he's got to battle, push real hard on the big Stenson to get position. And referees declared, can't push that hard, young man, to get position. As Lear battles in there, he'll take a seat. Amari Thomas back in. Furch is in the game, guarding Bacon as he comes up the floor.
Garrigan cannot afford to let Lake Mills get too far ahead here before halftime. They're already up by 12 as the defense has to find a way. Delger on the right side. Delger against Schwab. Schwab's in a little space. Now Stensrud has the top of the key. Outer hands to Mankey. Mankey across the foul line. Mankey drives in. Shot contested by Nemers, but a foul. And if that's on Nemers, that is number three.
Yeah, that's going to get Nemers right back out of the game and didn't get much of an opportunity to get his offense going inside. You know, he did a nice job jumping vertical, but that was just good body twisting by Mankey to draw the attention of the officials.
Mankey knocks down the free throw. Over 75.5% from the charity stripe last year as Manis checks back in after the two early fouls. Stensrud will take a break right before halftime. Nemers goes to the bench as well for Garrigan. Trayton Sink back into the ballgame. 33-20, Lake Mills on top. Second quarter action as Mankey tees it up and knocks it through to make it 34-20. This six-point lead has ballooned to 14 at the drop of a hat. And now Bishop Garrigan desperately needs a bucket before halftime. Joyce up top, guarded right now by Bacon. Thomas sets the screen as Joyce heads left. Joyce darting inside, jump stopping and dealing to Schwab in the corner. 1:10 left in the first half as Schwab gets turned 360 up top to Sink. Sink right over the lane and bounces to Furch. Furch back up top to Schwab. Eyes the bucket with 13 on the shot clock. Schwab, hand off to Joyce. Top of the key, Joyce tries to shake loose. Heads down the lane and the ball stripped. Manis has it, lobs it to Delger. Delger sails to the bucket and he lays it up and in.
Boy, Delger with 8 points in the last minute.
Yeah, if Lake Mills is getting that kind of production off the bench from Dellinger, they're going to be in a good spot this season as Schwab looks to the baseline and gets turned back out by Mankey. 40 seconds left in the quarter. Joyce to the baseline. Tough jumper on the way. Got nothing. Sailing in for the rebound is Furch, and Furch draws the foul with 35 seconds left in the quarter.
Boy, Furch battling there, going up strong with the ball. Old school. Gets the rebound. Says, I don't care if you're taller than me. I'm going to power up through, draw some contact, and they're going to say he wasn't shooting, that he got hackled on the floor.
Bishop Garrigan will send Michael Joyce to run the inbounds play. Furch pops open in the near corner and finds Sink on the wing. Shot clock off, game clock down to 31 seconds as Joyce rotates it to Schwab, eyes the bucket. Schwab one dribble in the pass near side to Sink. Hands it back off to Schwab in front of the Lake Mills bench. Lake Mills defense clapping and keeping the defense going. The bench is letting them hear it. Schwab to the baseline, finds Sink. Sink elbow jumper on the way and left it short. Rebound is taken by Manis. Now 10 seconds left in the quarter, and Lake Mills can really put a hurting on the Golden Bears here for buckets. 6 seconds left. Mankey in the lane. Dishes outside to Manis. Rotates it to Bacon. Bacon jumper at the horn. He knocks it down. Logan Bacon, a mid-range two at the buzzer, and Lake Mills has a big run to end the first half. They take a 6-point lead and turn it into an 18-point lead, just like that of a 12-0 scoring run. Lake Mills 38, Bishop Garrigan 20, as we've arrived at halftime on KLGA 92.7 and at the Elk on a Radio YouTube stream.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you gotta go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions, satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op, delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump It, they do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Albert Electric. Flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Grassmasters, growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments, quality apartments for rent, beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts, open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
From Bishop Garrigan High School is right now the Lake Mills Bulldogs lead the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears by a count of 38-20. Before we look at the boys' first half stats, we'll check in with Bishop Garrigan girls head coach Brandon Schwab and recap the 60-33 win against Lake Mills. Coach, first of all, obviously team got off to a little bit of a slow start, down 15-5 in the first, but they shook that pretty quickly, got back in front by halftime and pulled away in the second half. What were a few keys there to getting out of that slow start?
Well, we weren't hitting shots early, and then it allowed our defensive rotation was not good getting back on defense, and they got a few easies. You know, I mean, it came down to, you know, our rotation back on defense wasn't good, and, you know, Graceland picking up two fouls right away doesn't help our team out. You know, I mean, we've got to be able to get out of that first quarter without being in foul trouble.
And coach, you guys went to a 2-3 zone defense after starting off in man-to-man, and that was something that Lake Mills really seemed to struggle with for long periods of time. So what do you feel led to their struggles?
Well, you know, we're kind of a balanced team where we can play man or zone. You know, really we tried to do a little zone mixed in simply for the fact of, you know, with Graceland with two fouls, we were trying to, you know, get her to get out of that half with just two fouls, you know. But our zone really moved well. I thought we really you know, and we were going to go back to man, but I didn't see a reason in switching defenses when we were really kind of controlling the game on the defensive end.
Well, Coach, Graceland on the offensive end as well had a big night, career high in points at 25. And, you know, again, she spent some time on the bench after the 2 fouls in the first quarter, but really turned it on in the second half. Just speak on her kind of instincts down the post. She seems to get great positioning and always is on the same page as the guards.
Yeah, well, she's improving. You know, her post seals are improving. Her demanding of the basketball is improving. You know, all them things that, you know, you take for granted when you had Audie for 4 years, that it's just a learning curve, and Grayson's doing a great job. You know, she's such an asset for us as a team when she's in the game, because she gives us one thing we don't have a lot of, and it's hype, you know. So her being able to come in, but, you know, really proud of her, the way she's stayed with the game plan and the way she's been competing lately and to help this team.
And coach, it's one of those two where going into the game, you said, we're going to hold Taylor Vonnegut to 4 points. You say, Bishop Garrigan have a really good chance of winning. Yeah. So, you know, the defensive job on Vonnegut tonight really worked well for you guys.
Yeah, I thought, you know, in our zone, we really recognized where Sauer and Vonnegut were. You know, when we went to zone, that was my concern, is we were gonna lose a few of them for some open shots, and I didn't want either one of those girls to get going. I said, if you've got to sell out on them to miss a rotation, make them make the pass. You know, make them make the pass, but we need to sell out on our rotations to number two and number five, and I thought we did a really good job of covering them up. I mean, even the shots Sauer hit were contested shots. You know, they were contested shots, and that, and we were in a good defensive position. You know, and I also thought rebounding-wise, I thought Abby was really big. Abby and Grayson on the boards, of really controlling the boards tonight.
And, Coach, of course, the elephant in the room coming up as you guys make the trip to Newell Fonda for another state championship rematch on Thursday night. Obviously, the team was locked in on tonight's game, but just talk to me about the excitement that that Thursday non-conference match against Newell brings.
You know, we honestly haven't talked about it one bit until, you know, we will tomorrow for practice. And, yeah, it's a big game, you know, not only just because it's a state championship rematch. Well, not really a rematch because we both have a lot of new players, but, you know, they're the number two team in the state and we're the number 10 team in the state. It's a great, you know, for our young team, for our to get thrown in a wolf's den like Newell Fonda is, will be a good experience for our kids. I mean, I'm excited to see. I mean, are we going to rise to the challenge of what's in front of us, and you know, and get better each second of that game? It's going to take a better start than we did tonight. I promise that. So, just looking forward to it. Always looking forward to playing good teams, and they're an outstanding basketball team.
Well, Coach, we can't wait to see the game on Thursday night. We'll see you in Newell Fonda, and thanks again for your time at halftime.
All right, thanks.
That's Bishop Garrigan head coach Brandon Schwab talking about his team's 60-33 win against Lake Mills, as we'll step aside for a timeout and bring you the boys' second half after this on KLGA and the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
For over 40 years, Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons have maintained one mission: to provide excellence in orthopedic care. Their team of nine physicians offer specialized care in everything from arthroscopic same-day surgery to joint replacement, as well as hand and foot surgery, and have an orthopedic surgeon on call 24/7. Healthcare isn't about appointments, it's about taking care of people, and that's their specialty. Visit Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons on the web at nwiabone.com.
Thank you to these sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Kossuth Regional Health Center, make KRHC your home for healthcare.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, carrying steel and Toro products and Green Mountain pellet grills.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Runke Brothers Full Service. Experience the Runke Brothers difference for all your auto service and repair needs.
Erpelding Boyd & Company CPAs. They're not just about taxes.
Hy-Vee. Use the Fuel Saver card. Fill your cart, fuel your car.
North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Algona, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Erpelding Excavating Enterprises. Let them take care of your grading, excavating, and drainage needs.
AK's Chrome Kitchen. When you come in, your family.
All sponsors of this game broadcast. High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beisch, Jason Brace, Daniel Folt, and Michael Toth.
Kemco Tires, they're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 Agency, a fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm insurance agent in Algona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
EMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
At Security State Bank, we realize each customer has a unique set of needs and goals. That's why we place a greater value on providing outstanding customer service. All products and services are designed for customers within our local community. We value each customer that walks through our door and wants to give them the personalized attention they deserve. Find out why Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne is your partner in community banking. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Security State Bank.
One and a half minutes to go until the start of the second half from Bishop Garrigan High School. We thank girls head coach Brandon Trom for his time recapping their 60-33 win over Lake Mills as the Golden Bear girls now 4-0 on the season, heading to New Fonda on Thursday night. Meanwhile, in the boys' game, Lake Mills closed the first half on a 12-0 scoring run. They turned a 26-20 advantage into a 38-20 advantage at halftime. Overall, in the second quarter, Lake Mills outscored the Golden Bears 23-9, including that 12-0 spurt to end. I'm Tyler Lance. Beanie Bodie's my partner, and Beanie, you know, the old cliche in sports is defense wins championships. Obviously, Lake Mills has been impressive on offense so far, but I'm more impressed by their defense and the way they've really locked down the Golden Bears.
Yeah, they have really forced Garrigan to just try whatever they can to get an open look at the basket. They haven't given any open looks from the outside, from the perimeter, for Garrigan to get any threes up. And they forced Garrigan to get creative. Garrigan working really hard for any open look they get. And it's got to be a good one, because if they don't get a good open look, Lake Mills has been really tough on the boards.
Yeah, Lake Mills has had a great rebounding night, and it's been led by Aiden Stensrud, as Stensrud has gotten offensive rebound after offensive rebound, and the second chance points are something that Lake Mills has really been able to punish Bishop Garrigan with. Stensrud right now of 10 points, Lance Helming of 10, Nash Delger of 8 points for Lake Mills. On the Garrigan side of things, Michael Joyce leading the way with 9, and you have a couple players scattered around at 4 points on the scoreboard. But 38-20 at the half, as we approach the start of the third quarter, Bishop Garrigan, I don't really recall too many three-point attempts, let alone three-point makes in the first half, as Lake Mills has really just shut off everything for the Golden Bear offense at this point. Bishop Garrigan had that season-opening 85-51 win against Belmont Clemmy and lost to Western Christian's past Saturday 75-50 as they shot under 37% from the field in that game. Likely around that same percentage-wise in this ball game as the Golden Bears start the second half with the basketball. Bauer has it, and now it's Nemers as Golden Bears head right to left on the radio dial. Joyce on the left wing gets a screen from Mahler, sidesteps into a three-point ball, and that one comes up well short. Mahler sailed in for the rebound, and he gets called for the foul.
Bears got a good look off a set play at halftime. Just didn't drop for him, but a good start to the second half. Getting an open look as here comes Bacon walking the ball up the floor with an 18-point lead. They're showing no signs of hurry.
Yeah, they heard us talking about knocking a three, so they tried to knock one down, but not an easy shot for the freshman Michael Joyce, sidestepping as Helming fades back and knocks it down. Schwab went to the floor looking to draw the foul, but Helming once again connects, and he has 12 points.
Well, just like the game started, Helming is their best offensive weapon.
Joyce down the lane, the floater is left short, and Stensrud grabs the basketball out of the air. Lake Mills on top of Bishop Garrigan. Here's Mankey launching and can't knock that one down. 7:13 on the clock. Schwab the other way, sidesteps, gets the rack and scores.
Good strong move to the hoop by Schwab from the left-hand side of the hoop, making it easy.
6 points now for Carter Schwab. 6:59 on the clock in the third quarter. I believe 40-24 is the score. They have it 40-22 on the Garrigan board right now, as they didn't give Schwab that last bucket. In the corner, Lake Mills launches with Bacon. In and out, no good, and Nemers grabs the rebound for the Golden Bears.
Oh, a concerted effort to rebound better.
Underneath the basket, it's Bauer. Bauer hesitates and puts it up and in.
Little up fake by Bauer, the senior, getting us some space.
40-24, make it 40-26. Again, I think they have it wrong here at the Garrigan High School scoreboard, but maybe I have it wrong, but I think it's 40-26 right now. As down on the post, Stensrud has it against Nemers, spins away from the big man, reverses and scores. Stensrud navigating the baseline to perfection, and he has 12 for Lake Mills. 42-26, Joyce finds Nemers, foul line extended on the right side, clanks the jumper off the glass, no good. 2 minutes gone here in quarter number three. Up ahead, Manis finds Stensrud in the lane against Nemers again, spins right, Nemers staying in front. Bauer peels the basketball away, and Garrigan forces a turnover. Now Joyce with a little pace up the court. Joyce sidesteps Bacon and draws the foul.
Boy, both teams getting out and run a little bit here. Lear coming into the game. I think they're going to pick up some tempo here. Bauer running the floor well. Well, score still at 42-24. Let's see if we can figure this out, Tyler. It was 20 points for the Bears at halftime.
And Bishop Garrigan has scored twice since halftime, correct? Because Garrigan was down 38-20, and now it's 42-20. Maybe I am.
So that would be right. Now it's 25 on the board.
All right, 25. All right, sorry, folks. It's easy to get things backwards on the scoreboard.
Well, Schwab had a bucket, and Bauer had a bucket. Did anyone else have a bucket?
I don't think so.
All right.
No use relitigating it at this point. We'll go off the scoreboard. 45-24.
Let's just talk basketball.
No more being a doubting Thomas as Joyce knocks down the three throw, and Joyce has 11 points.
Let's just talk about
26.
Let's just talk about how nice the uniforms are the rest of this game. 42-26. They're looking good out there, both these teams. I think it's going to be a helter-skelter second half as both teams are going to open it up here.
Hellman gets double teamed in the post and a foul. Schwab was on the backside, Bauer coming in from the front side. And they'll get Schwab on that one, his third.
Ooh, that's not good for the Bears. Schwab, premier ball handler for the Bears. Him and Joyce doing all the ball handling duties. But I guess Furch coming back off the injury.
Oh, nice find of Stensrud off the inbounds play, and he comes wide open for the layup. 14 points now for Stensrud, and a 44-26 advantage by Lake Mills. Joyce has it up near half court, down 44-26. Schwab on the left wing, finds Mahler in the corner. Mahler fakes one way, picks it up, and heads it over to Schwab. Schwab splits down the center of the lane, and he'll draw the fouls. He floats it up and in. That foul's on the floor, though, so the bucket does not count.
Boy,
that'll be foul number two against Lake Mills.
He hit the deck, and he still managed to get the ball to go into the rim. Schwab is very strong at driving the ball to the hoop. The Bears are going to take it out on the side. Might as well run that same play they did to start the half with. That got an open look.
Schwab looks and bounces it into Mahler. Far side of the court with 5:23 on the clock. Mahler gives the handoff to Schwab. Schwab gives it right back to Mahler on the wing, eyes the bucket. Mahler looking to heat it up offensively. He's been off the board so far tonight as Schwab catches the pass from Joyce, leaves the free ball short. Mahler nearly had the rebound, but it goes into the hands of Bacon for Lake Mills. Still 44-26. Mankey steps into a left side three-point ball. It's a little bit long, and a whistle.
Oh, Lear and Mankey kind of tangled up. Mankey went up for the three-pointer. Lear went to box him out, and they kind of got tangled. And Lear's going to get called for the foul on the box out.
So Schwab a three fouls, Lear a three fouls, and Mankey heading to the charity stripe for two more.
Well, I'll give it to Lear and the Garrigan crowd, or the Garrigan crew out there playing basketball. They came out of the halftime determined not to let Lake Mills get the rebounding battle. Nemer started off with some great box out position. All the Bears boxing out, doing their job, and Lear just answering the call there, but he boxed Mankey out into the stands after Mankey took that three-pointer.
And Mankey knocks down the second, and it's 45-26 Lake Mills. One more coming on the free-throw line. But these were the top two rebounding teams in the conference last year. Bishop Garrigan, 36.6 rebounds per game. Lake Mills, 33 rebounds a game. It was very rare last season that Bishop Garrigan would be out-rebounded. If there's one thing you could rely on a night-to-night basis, it was Bishop Garrigan in the plus in the rebounding. But tonight, Lake Mills has had Stensrud with a ferocious effort on the glass. Stensrud nearly stole it away from Lear. Lear in the high post, bouncing it right to Bauer in the corner. Bauer back to Lear in the paint, and the ball goes out of bounds, out of Lear's reach.
A little 20-point advantage here for Lake Mills. Amari Thomas is going to come in for Lear.
So Thomas into the ball game. He has just one foul. The Golden Bears have, as you said, had Schwab a three. They had Lear a three as well. Nemers of a couple on the board.
You know, not a lot of teams in the top of Iowa are going to be able to match up size-wise with Lake Mills, but Garrigan actually does right now. Thomas, Schwab, and Mueller, all big men in there.
Right of lane, Helming. Helming gets it off the glass. No good. Schwab with the help defense, or Joyce with the help defense, as they outlap to Mahler. Mahler under the back, can't knock the layup down, and Mankey has the rebound. Back the other way come the Bulldogs. Bacon across the lanes, stops the elbow. Tried to pass it to Mankey in the corner, but Mahler caught back up in transition and knocked it out of bounds. So 4:15 on the clock. 20-point lead right now for Lake Mills over Bishop Garrigan. Bulldogs trying for a 3-0 start to the season after they went 23-1 last year. That one loss, the final playoff game is, oh man, Bacon got hit in the face, but they let them play. That was an off arm coming down on the chin, as now Stensrud drives and lays it in.
Yeah, Bacon just standing there. He wants to come out of the game because he's bleeding on his lip, I think. Bauer was playing defense, and Bauer put his arm up right into Bacon's lip, nose, face, took a shot right in the mouth, unintentional by Bauer, who was just flapping at the ball. So he's going to have to come out and attend to that wound here for a second.
Nash Delger checks in, and boy, how big was Delger in changing that momentum in the first half?
He was
a big part of that 12-0 run.
Yeah, absolutely.
Knocked down 2 3-pointers. He had 8 points off the bench in the first half. Besides Stensrud, he may be the MVP tonight for Lake Mills.
Well, it was a 6-point game, and suddenly Delger had 2 open 3-point shots, nailed them both, then got a run out layup. Young man scored 8 points in a minute, and suddenly 6 points lead was just a figment of desire for the Bear team, because it's been all Lake Mills ever since.
Timeout by Bishop Garrigan. Delger for 8 points so far tonight. We'll take that timeout with the Golden Bears on KLGA 92.7 and at the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with Money Pass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the Money Pass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue Money Pass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at moneypass.com. Money Pass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
Lake Mills on top of Bishop Garrigan, 48-26 here on Hometown Radio, KLGA, and the Algona Radio YouTube live stream. As I'm Tyler Lance alongside Beanie Bodie, the Golden Bears will have the basketball coming out of the timeout. They will have 3 timeouts left after that last one, as Schwab will inbound to Joyce. The Bishop Garrigan freshman takes the basketball in the backcourt, and we are rolling again in quarter number three with 3:54 on the clock. Joyce top of the key, guarded by Delger. Joyce stops the elbow, fades back for a jumper, and he rattles it in.
What a classic throwback jump shot. Kids are mostly layups and threes these days, but Joyce has a nice mid-range jumper.
Yeah, we're starting to discover Joyce can really shoot from anywhere on the court. Not that that's that much of a surprise, but he is really showing the arsenal for Bishop Garrigan through the first 2+ games. Lake Mills has Gatsky for the basketball, deals to the cutting, Stensrud off the window, he put it in, and the foul. Just like that, Lake Mills back up 50-28.
Oh, a very beautiful cut there by Stensrud, and good awareness by his teammates to find him. Boy, if I had a big man like that cutting the hoop, I'd make an effort to find him too.
I mean, what do you do to defend Stensrud? Because you have the bigger numbers, but then Stensrud uses that spin move and has the speed advantage. But against a smaller player, Stensrud is still just so strong to overpower them as he knocks down the free throw.
Nice spin move. I mean, you can try to jam the cutter and keep him from getting to where he wants to go, but he's got good footwork.
19 points by Stensrud, as Joyce working with 13 of his own right now near half court, guarded by Delger. Joyce waiting for Schwab to set the screen. Joyce heads right. Schwab drops off the screen, steps in for a jumper at the foul line, and knocks it down.
Good offense by the guards up top. Did a little pick and roll, pick and pop. Schwab knocks down a jumper.
Schwab of 8 points. Shot just under 49% from the field last year. As Getzy gets it outside to Helming. Helming fakes the spin one way, spins the other way. Tough jumper, no good. And Schwab vacuums in the rebound. The Bishop Garrigan sophomore strides with the court. Quick pass to Muller in the corner. Lets it fly for three. In and out, no good. Thomas had the rebound briefly, but a foul against Lake Mills on the loose basketball. There's a lid on the basket right now for Drew Muller. Just 1 of 8 on threes so far this season.
Yeah, and he's a good shooter, too. Lake Mills kind of get called for the foul there, but I think it was Michael Joyce came skying in. He's done that a couple times where he comes flying in out of nowhere and tries to keep the rebound alive. Amari Thomas, I think, had a pretty good handle on it, but a foul called. Tate first comes into the game.
Both teams have 3 fouls. Thomas scrapping against Getzky to try to get position in the post as Furch has the top of the key. Furch right of the lane finds Thomas in the short corner down on the right side. Thomas spins 360 and then does it again as he gets it outside to Joyce. Joyce cuts into the lane, rises for a jumper. It got tipped and Getzky has the basketball in the paint.
Good position by Getzky. Well, Bears came out owning the rebounding battle and not much to be had since those foul calls.
Delger on the right wing comes up top to Gatsky, rotates it left to Helming. Helming takes a couple dribbles right and finds Bacon on the perimeter. Down the right corner, it's Delger. Make that Gatsky as he finds Mankey in the post, working against Muller back to the bucket. Muller knocked the ball away, loose on the floor, and a jump ball.
Yeah, good hands by Muller. Muller's got very good hands. I mean, Drew Muller's a guy that played guard when he was a little boy, and then he's done nothing except grow. And now he's just got this, he's this big man with good hands. He can shoot 3-pointers, but he is a very versatile player.
Yeah, much like Joyce, in a little bit of a different way, Muller can hit from anywhere as well. He'll shoot the three. He's one of the better players who will also take the mid-range jump shot as well. as Lake Mills has the basketball. Top of the key three-pointer, Helming missed it right, and Thomas snatches the rebound out of the sky. Joyce races the other way against Gelger. Behind the back dribble avoids Bacon as Joyce now weaves towards the near side. Side steps into a triple, and he swishes it! Michael Joyce doing it himself on that possession, and he has 16 points.
I don't think that young man had any intent to run some offense there. Amari Thomas got the rebound, made the outlet pass, and Joyce said, I'm just going to go do some scoring.
Now Lake Mills will try to answer. Helming posting up against Joyce. Menke drives instead, bangs his way inside, and draws another foul. Four fouls on Bishop Garrigan this quarter, and Menke making yet another trip to the free throw line for two shots.
Yeah, and that's pretty automatic for Kyle Menke if he gets to the free throw line. I'm sorry, Eli Menke, Kyle Menke, the coach.
Hey, Kyle Menke will not be shooting any free throws today.
If the coach does run out there to shoot a free throw, I hope he gets at least a technical foul.
And it's knocked down by Menke. Eli Menke, that is.
Wouldn't it be fun to see a positive technical foul, not just because someone's irate and yelling at the refs if they were actually doing something silly or fun, but still against the rules?
I cannot picture a situation without coming to play.
Well, I think I just came up with one. You just go out and shoot the ball.
Lake Mills back up by 20 as Menke has 12 points, knocking down the two free throws. I've been impressed with the evolution of Eli Menke's game as Thomas is fouled in low post by Getzky. I said it earlier tonight, but Menke, I mean, really, he was primarily a three-point shooter for the most part last year, but he is really attacking the basket tonight. I don't know if that's a regular thing for Lake Mills, just a matchup thing, but Menke is really being aggressive in this game.
Yeah, and someone has to do it because after Stensland, first name, I can't remember, graduated, he was so good at taking the ball into the paint and creating for the big men, and that is a void left by his graduation, so someone's got to do that for Lake Mills. Bacon does that a little bit, but it's Eli Menke seems to have taken up that yoke.
Yeah, Denton Kingland was the graduated Lake Mills Bulldog from last year. As Furch has it on the right wing, Wempen into the ballgame for Lake Mills. Thomas in the paint, and he'll draw the foul against Menke.
Yep. Amari Thomas showing some vertical there. He really can get up off the floor. He leaps and just needs to work on his finishing offense, and he'll be a force inside. Keeps working at that game.
So Thomas heads to the free throw line for two shots. As we talked, Beanie, in that Belmont-Clemmie game, as Thomas was the free throw short. We talked about a potential dunk contest among the Garrigan team.
That's
Thomas
right.
Would be one who may be involved in that.
Yeah, you know, for as much basketball as kids play, a lot of these players for Garrigan, like Thomas, fairly new to the game, and you can see it in the rawness of his game. He missed his second free throw, but, like, boy, just with some little time in the gym and some timely advice, he's going to be a good one.
Bacon on the right wing comes up top to Wempen. Wempen has Thomas on him. Cutting and getting the ball is Delger. Delger in the far corner, sidestepping, and Schwab stays in front of him. 54 seconds left in the third quarter, and Lake Mills maintaining a steady 20-point lead over Bishop Garrigan as Wempen gets the basketball back. Helming just to the right of center, bolted into Menke, dropped the ball, but that was because Sink fouled him. That is foul number five against Bishop Garrigan, and once again, Eli Menke heading to the charity stripe.
Yeah, he's creating a matchup problem. He can shoot the three over the top of you because he's a tall young man. He can also play inside. He has the shorter Sink on him there. Sink just got a little ticky-tack foul. He got a lot of ball, but got a little bit of arm too. And now here goes the free throw shooter Eli Menke to the line, and he is just automatic. So another strategy for Lake Mills, get that young man to the free throw line, and that's what they're doing now.
All right, Beanie, I thought of a scenario where Kyle Menke could shoot free throws.
All right, please, please.
If we bring back the old school baseball player coach,
Kyle
Menke puts himself on the roster, checks into the ball game, and shows the young players how it's done.
Oh, every washed up man who loves his glory days dream, a chance to get back in the game.
Furch bounces it to Thomas on the near side. Thomas waits for Joyce to curl around to take the handoff. Joyce, baseline jumper, airballed it long. Thomas got it right back, though, and his layup is too strong off the glass. Ripped away by Wempen on the rebound, and on a foul against Bishop Garrigan.
Oh, that's going to be on first. So, you know, look at Thomas. They're going to show some frustration. He works so hard, gets a great rebound, but just puts it too hard off the glass. And that's just experience. And that's what these early games are. I mean, it's 55-33. Barring a great comeback here against a really good Lake Mills team, Garrigan's going to go down here, but they're going to gain a lot of experience during this matchup tonight.
Free throw is short by Keaton Wempen, a 6'3 junior for Lake Mills. 22 seconds left in the quarter as Lake Mills continues to control the ball game up 55-33, and Wempen rattles on a foul shot. Lake Mills brings Alex Manis off the bench once again. Manis picked up those two early fouls for Lake Mills. Spent a lot of time on the bench in the first half. But Lake Mills going deeper off the bench this season than last year. We've mentioned multiple times, Nash Delger, that huge scoring spurt right before halftime. He's on the floor right now playing defense against Furch. Joyce with 13 seconds drives in, takes the contact, and draws the foul. Joyce just pinballing off of bodies in the lane. We'll head to the charity stripe again for two shots.
Yeah, Tyler, heading into this fourth quarter, just a few ticks left in the third. It's 56-33. I think we can safely say that neither of these teams early on the season are scoring at the clip that they did last year, nor the clip that they hope to once they get their offenses going this season.
Yeah, no doubt about it. These were the two teams that averaged the top scoring totals from the top of Iowa West last season as the free throw is up and it's good. And this is something football coaches say a lot, but it could apply to basketball too. The defense is ahead of the offense early in the season, and I think that's not always as true in basketball as football, but I think in many cases it is true, especially when you talk about a Garrigan team that probably wasn't in the gym getting as many jumpers as
right.
usual. When you talk about football, Lake Mills is a playoff football team as well, so their season started a bit later than the past couple of seasons. So both teams probably still looking for that touch on the jumper.
For sure, and people aren't as meshed together. They're not quite sure how to get open and how to move. So there's a lot fewer easy buckets early in the season that are created by good ball movement.
Lake Mills with the basketball. 56-35 is the advantage right now as Mankey shoots a right-wing three-point ball. Missed it right. Rebound is tipped up and in, and it will not fall at the end of the quarter as the tip does not drop. But Lake Mills right now leading 56-35, heading into the final 8 minutes of basketball action on KLGA 92.7 and the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you gotta go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions, satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op, delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump It, they do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Albert Electric, flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Grassmasters, growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments, quality apartments for rent, beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts, open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
With an 18-15 scoring advantage in the third quarter, they lead Bishop Garrigan 56-35 as Lake Mills Bulldogs look for their 53rd straight top of Iowa West win. Their last loss in the conference was back on February 7th of 2020, 58-56 against Forest City. And barring a huge comeback by Garrigan, that streak will continue tonight. Schwab will try to engineer that comeback as he reverses on the layup and misses, and Mankey grabs the rebound. Quickly up the court, Manis in the far corner. Gets it to Bacon. Now back in the corner, Manis. Manis rises for a three-point ball, and he swishes it. His first field goal of the game, and Lake Mills up 59-35. Now Schwab going to work on the other end. Bangs his way inside, missed the layup. Bauer tried to keep it alive, but Manis picks it up off the hardwood, and now Bacon races the other way. Bacon passes to Mankey in the corner. Mankey drives baseline. Big contact of Bauer and the foul. How about that football move right there? That was a shoulder-to-chest contact as Bauer will pick up his first foul on the block.
Well, Bauer wisely is not going to let Menke go baseline and get an easy layup there. Got to make him earn it.
From the baseline, Bacon looking and finding Menke in the corner. Now it's Helming going to work against Joyce. Helming spins right. Joyce stays in front. Helming banks it off the window and scores anyways.
Well, I mean, you've got Helming, the upperclassman, Joyce, the freshman, one-on-one, that advantage is going to go Helming every time, despite how much leaping Michael can do.
Joyce did a good job staying in front of the spin move that time, but Helming just always hits it flush off the window. As Joyce flips behind Nemers, it was tipped by Nemers and out of bounds. Nemers was trying to campaign and say Stensrud touched it, but Nemers called for that last touch.
Yeah, you start to see some weary faces on both teams right now. We are early in the season, right, Tyler? Some players are looking a little peaked on both teams. Bacon walks the floor up right now. He took a shot in the face earlier.
Yeah, that basketball conditioning is definitely a little bit different as you get used to the up and down of the game. Near side of the court, Logan Bacon now comes up top to Mankey. Mankey in the lane, rises for the jumper. In and out as Joyce grabs the rebound. All right, Coach Beanie, I'll ask you this. Back when you were coaching, what was your favorite conditioning drill to put the players through that they all hated?
Oh, they absolutely hated the one where I just, every time I blow the whistle, they change directions, whether it's defensive slides or just all up and backs, boy, because it's just, it's the best drill to mimic that stop and go, like, because you never know when you have to change directions in basketball. But, boy, it's just, it's a ruthless drill.
Stensrud swats a Bauer shot out of the air as Bishop Garrigan will keep it after the block shot goes out of bounds. Yeah, I can imagine your players were not a big fan of you after that. You weren't the cool science teacher Beanie Bodie anymore.
Tyler.
You were mean coach of the whistle Beanie Bodie.
I'm afraid to say they weren't big fans of me before that drill either. Hey, there's a bucket.
Carter Schwab, a corner pocket three-point ball, as he has 11 points right now, and it's 61-38. Bishop Garrigan still trailing Lake Mills. Manis comes up top to Stensrud, now to the right to Helming. Back over to the left wing to Bacon. Bauer creeps out, tries to poke the basketball away. Now Bacon goes to work. Bacon pushes off of Bauer. Offensive foul. Bauer helped sell that one a little bit as Bacon is frustrated, but that'll go against Lake Mills, their first of the quarter.
Boy, Justin Bauer, well done. He slid. Boy, I've seen him slide in the baseball field, but he went flying across that floor as Bacon extended his arm. And, you know, all the referee has to do is take a flash picture of that arm extended and a guy falling across the floor, and you got to call a charge.
Yeah, a lack of friction between the jersey and floor helped out that long slide as well into home plate. Pass knocked away in the lane. Here comes Helming. A nice dish to Manis. Shot rejected, but a foul. I think that was a clean block initially, but the downswing by Bauer got him, and Manis will shoot two.
Yeah, Bauer really working hard, running the floor well. He is a fun player to watch.
Yeah, Bauer bringing the energy, and I said this early in the game, but if you asked going into the night who led Bishop Garrigan an assist through the first two games, Bauer might not have been your first guess, but that would be the answer, as he is really passing the ball very nicely to complement Schwab and Joyce as Manis misses on the first free throw.
Yeah, he's just all-around athlete, track star. I don't think anyone can be less than thrilled with how his football season went, coming off an injury. Just lights out defensive back for the Bears, and yeah, and now he's having a heck of a basketball season.
Yeah, great wide receiver as well, and touchdown throwing pass against Remsen St. Mary on the trick play.
That's
that Garrigan
right.
fans will remember.
What a season for that young man.
Michael Joyce, deep three-pointer, missed it right. Nemers tries to chase down the rebound, but getting to the spot first is Delger. Lob of the court to Helming under the bucket, and Helming sets it in for the easy two. 16 points by Lance Helming. He's having another big night for Lake Mills as well. And we will have a whistle and a stoppage. Coach Meister and the Golden Bears want a timeout with 5 minutes left and a 64-38 lead by Lake Mills. It's a 30-second timeout, so we will keep it right here. Well, Beanie, this one looks to be getting away from Bishop Garrigan as they head into the game on Thursday night in Wofonda.
Yeah, they almost had 3 points right there. That's happened to me when I was coaching as well. You want to talk to your team, so you just think as soon as we get across half court, call a timeout. Coach Meister's ready to call the timeout. But as soon as Schwab heard that whistle, he launched a three-pointer, and of course it goes in. And it happens every single time a coach plans to call a timeout and a player shoots the ball. It always goes in. But, yeah, I don't think the Bears are going to have a comeback. But, boy, Tyler, the rest of the way, you just want to see them grow as a team here. You don't want to have garbage minutes early in the season like this. They got 5 minutes to put something together and a good Lake Mills team to work on it against. So,
and this is why Bishop Garrigan has the original starters back in right now. They, even if they don't play the full last 5 minutes, I think Coach Meister really wants to get a good 2 or 3 minutes out of the starters, have some positive momentum going into the Newell Fonda game on Thursday, and see somebody build off of it. Schwab catches the pass, drives the baseline, and he will draw the foul. That'll go against Manis for the second on Lake Mills of this quarter.
Yeah, and they're doing it. They come out of that timeout. They run a nice little set play to get Schwab open on the baseline. He's taking it to the hoop. I mean, yeah, work on getting some good offensive looks in that you can use later.
Mahler back to the bucket. Now gets it to Nemers in the high post. Nemers takes one dribble and underhands to Schwab, top of the key. Schwab drives the lane, creates space against Helming, and a whistle and a foul. With 4:45 left, that one will go against Helming, and I've got to say, I think Garrigan may have caught a break there. I think Carter Schwab may have used that off arm there to create some space.
Yeah, that time it was, I think, Schwab's arm that was extended, but no matter, the referee called Helming, and he's just going to move on and put his hands on his hips, and he wouldn't be so happy if that was his fourth foul, but that's just the third one on Lance Helming with 4:45 here left to go in the game, and pretty well in hand here for the Lake Mills Bulldogs. Now Helming's got to block out the big man, Logan Nemers.
Schwab misses the second free throw, and he will stay at 12 points. 64-39 in favor of Lake Mills. as Getzky has it on the baseline, finds Helming in the corner, three-point ball left short, and Mahler picks the ball out of the air and gets it out to Schwab quickly. Bodies go falling to the ground away from the play. Schwab has it to 4:27 on the clock, finds Mahler in the near corner, guarded by Eli Mankey. Mahler takes two dribbles and unloads it to Schwab on the right side. Now Schwab comes back to the left, backs up against Helming and hands it off to Joyce. Joyce guarded by Dellinger. Joyce spins towards the paint. Now spins and fades back for the jumper, and he knocks it down again. That move is lethal for Michael Joyce.
Boy, that's a beautiful fadeaway for a freshman basketball player. You can't defend that play. And now Lake Mills, boy, as most teams do when they have the game well in hand, getting a little loose and undisciplined with their offense, just looking to score points.
Dellinger launches a three-point ball. In and out, no good. Almost knocked that one down again as the whole Lake Mills bench was ready to rise up and celebrate. Joyce now with his second straight 20-plus point game as Mankey corner free swishes it.
Oh, nice little screen there by Stendrud. Kind of set up a wall to protect Mankey in the corner.
Mankey helped Lake Mills become the number one three-point shooting team in the conference last year at 35%, as Joyce will be fouled by Dellinger, foul number four on Lake Mills with 3:32 left. You know, Beanie, I'll say this too. Michael Joyce, he didn't really look to score a whole lot in that game against Belmont Clemmy, but the past two games, 23 points against Western Christian, 20 points tonight, he's really starting to get into initiate mode on offense.
Oh, for sure. And like his sister, he's just no conscience out there, meaning he just goes for it. He just, you know, regardless of the situation in the game, he gets the ball and he has just one mission, and to get that ball into the hoop. And, man, that's what you want. He is an offensive powerhouse here in the making. Shown us some really impressive stuff tonight against whole Western Christian. He knocked down some contested threes. Looked good against, just the beginning here for that young man. 41 points in the game, and he's got 20 of them.
Lake Mills is going to call off the dogs and bring the starters out of the ball game. No need to get starters into any bad habits as well over the last 3:30. On the floor right now, Kyle Huntsey coming in for Lake Mills. They also have Getzky on the floor. Back in Keaton Wempen as well. Dellinger will stay in. And also checking in number five, Kane Cook.
That's a good point, because sometimes they were starting to do some bad habits there, starting to just be a little bit lazy on offense, just chuck it around and see if they can give everybody a bucket. So might as well get these youngsters in there. Joyce just slipped and face planted on the floor, took a hard fall there.
You could hear that reverberating up here. That was a hard spill.
He hit hard. He beats up and says, "No, I'm all right," when the coaches ask me, "Want to come out?"
Up top, Dellinger, guarded by Joyce. Here comes the screen for Lake Mills as Huntsey sets it. Now Getzky driving in, slicing the bucket. Shot blocked by Lear, but a foul. On the floor right now for Garrigan, it's Lear, Sink, Joyce, Schwab, and Bauer. And the trio of subs are getting set to check in. Gredeman, Furch, and Thomas sitting by the scoring table right now, as that's foul number four against Lear. Gets east of the line for two, 67-41 in favor of Lake Mills, as that foul shot comes up short. Well, it'll be interesting to see what happened tonight elsewhere on the top of Iowa West. Undefeated North Union against undefeated Forest City in boys high school basketball. North Union, an impressive win against ELC, Esther Lincoln Central last night. Forest City was 2-0 so far, so.
Was that also a girls matchup too, Tyler?
That was a girls' matchup as well, as ELC defeated North Union 68-31. ELC ranks number six in Class 3A for the girls, as that foul shot is up and good. Yeah, so Forest City against North Union girls, that may be a top of Iowa West leaderboard type of matchup as well, as Forest City's girls right now off to a 4-0 start. Power dribble for Lear, shot blocked. Huntsey rejected it, and Lake Mills has the basketball with Dellinger of 2:53 left. 68-41 Lake Mills in the corner. Weapon three-point try, in and out. Sink grabs the rebound. 2:44 left. Furch runs the offense for Bishop Garrigan. Backs up and picks up his dribble as he flings left to Sink. Eyes the bucket, looking inside for Lear, but can't create space. Now Thomas has it top of the key. 2.5 minutes left. Bishop Garrigan have two more games this week as they face Newell Fond on Thursday, Eagle Grove Friday. Furch turn around, can't knock the jumper down. Ball tipped out of bounds, goes back to Lake Mills. And Daniel Weiss will come off the bench for Bishop Garrigan to continue to empty out the reserves as Sink checks out.
Well, it wasn't the close contest that we've seen between these two teams the last few years. So early season contests just didn't go the way of the exciting broadcast that we love to do, Tyler, as Lake Mills has us well in hand. Another nice cut to the basket.
That's Kane Cook with the two, his first bucket of the night, as Lake Mills is up 70-41. But Lake Mills is flexing their muscle. And I'll tell you this. I said this off the air, but I'll say it on the air too. I'm at the point right now with Lake Mills where I will believe that they're going to lose a top of Iowa West game when I actually see them lose one. I mean, this is an incredible streak right now. You think about what the Garrigan girls have done with their top of Iowa West streak. Lake Mills' streak is only a couple games behind that.
Wow, and yeah, Garrigan was so close last year at this matchup a year ago, but not going to be today as Daniel Meiss comes in. Big number two comes in the game. So it'll be Meiss, Lear, Amari Thomas, Ben Gredeman, and Tate Furch are the five Bears going to finish out these last 2 minutes even on the clock.
Lear will shoot the free throws here, down 70-41 as the first one rattles in and out. The other thing for Bishop Garrigan, too, last year they caught Lake Mills early in the season when Lake Mills had a lot of new players working into the starting lineup after some graduations from the previous year. This year, Lake Mills catches Bishop Garrigan after a long state football run where Lake Mills has four or five starters back and more stability. So this is one where it's a tough time of the season to match up against the best team in the conference. And Garrigan finds themselves down 70-42 right now.
Yeah, very good point, Tyler, here as Dellinger dribbles out front with the ball, Furch on him.
Dellinger gives the basketball up to Wempen. Now Huntsey has it, guns it down to the baseline, hit it off the backboard. That pass was a rocket coming in, and now Furch has the basketball the other way. Behind the back dribble, Furch trying to keep it safe. One-legged jumper on the way, and it drops in off the soft touch.
Good hands by the quarterback there. Getting two, here comes Dellinger, guarded by Furch.
Dellinger passes left to Getzky on the perimeter, fakes the shot, wants to drive, and a foul against Bishop Garrigan. They're fourth of the quarter with 1:25 left.
One more, and Lake Mills will be shooting free throws as is. They'll take it out. Minute 25 left in the game. Each team's going to get it at least two more times, I'd say.
Trey Houston in the ballgame for Lake Mills, the senior playing for the first time tonight. Jeremiah Jensen as well, a 6'3 junior for the Bulldogs. So they've gotten everyone on the roster, at least a little bit of run so far tonight. Or nearly everyone on the roster, I should say, as Huntsey spins away from trouble. Three-point ball from the left wing, Wempen off the back of the cup. And Thomas grabs the rebound. It's raked out of there by Cook, but it's picked up by Meiss on the loose ball. Finds Furch with 108 left. Furch slices into the lane, powers it up, no good. Thomas off his board. Thomas off the window, and he spun it home. 70-46. First 2 points for Thomas of the night. And we're down to the final 56 seconds in this one as Lake Mills will drop Bishop Garrigan to 1-2. Corner pocket three, Jensen, but an offensive foul before that as Cook went barreling into Furch.
Yeah, Cook gave up the ball and just kept sprinting, ran over the wall that was Tate Furch. Gredeman's going to take it out of bounds here.
So Bishop Garrigan has it back with 51 seconds left. Lake Mills looking to make one final substitution here as Wempen is going to the bench.
I'm hoping the Bears get to 50 points here as the officials are going to call a meeting together and make sure something's correct. I think perhaps one of the subs has the wrong number.
Might be, yeah, wrong jersey number, I think, might be the issue here as they try to figure that out.
Are we going to have a technical foul with 50 seconds left in the game? I think we are.
That would help Bishop Garrigan get to the 50-point
yes,
marker calling for a beanie.
Yeah, you got to have those numbers right in the playbook. And he said, yeah, it's going to be a technical foul. And the referee said, hey, Coach Meiser, who do you want to shoot the free throws? We're going to have a technical foul in a 70-46 game. Tate Furch gets the honor.
They want Mr. QB1 to shoot the free throws. As Furch has 2 points so far tonight, he'll look to add to that.
He's going to shoot it with his surgically repaired right arm, and it works.
So it drops in 70-47 right now. Lake Mills on top of Bishop Garrigan.
Tate Furch, he's in the drama. He's in the play as well. And he pantomimes like he's getting high fives from his teammates after he makes that high five.
He did it both times.
He's a character, Tate Furch. He's a fun one.
Yeah, he has the kind of confidence you need from your starting quarterback.
And he really has the appreciation and love of his teammates here. He's going to be a good leader. Or I should say he is so far.
Well, believe it or not, Beanie, this is on track to be Lake Mills' lowest scoring game of the season as they scored 93 against Belmont Clemmie and 75 against West Hancock. Right now up 70-48. Not much consolation, though, for the Golden Bears as Lear's under the bucket. Can't hit from a tough angle. And Houston grabs the rebound with 33 seconds left. One more possession offensively for Lake Mills in all likelihood as the handoff goes to Huntsey. Huntsey flips it over to number 11, who's the technical foul unidentified player for Lake Mills. Now 22 seconds left, offensive board. Huntsey foul line jumper missed it right, and Thomas sails in for the rebound. Furch checks the clocks. He comes across half court. Final 13 seconds of this one as he finds Gretemann on the wing. Gretemann looking to get in the scorebook, gets it back out to Furch. Furch of 8 seconds, Furch left of the lane, floats it off the glass and puts it in. Furch with 6 points as the final couple seconds will tick away in this one. And Lake Mills continues their dominant conference winning streak. It is 53 in a row on the top of Iowa West for the Lake Mills Bulldogs and a 3-0 start to the season in conference play as they knock off the Golden Bears tonight by a final count of 70-50. We'll step aside for a quick timeout. Wrap this game up next on Hometown Radio KLGA and the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Algona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle. Passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Algona and Armstrong. Keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
Signworks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Algona Tree Service.
Sports Club members bringing you this game.
Tonight's game on Hometown Radio KLGA's Lake Mills Bulldogs improved to 3-0 on the season, all of those being top of Iowa West wins, and they knock off the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears by a final count of 70-50. I'm Tyler Lance alongside Beanie Bodies. A couple quick final numbers for tonight look like this. The scoring by quarter went 15-11 in favor of Lake Mills in the first, then a 23-9 scoring advantage in the second. Lake Mills really won the game by ending the first half on a 12-0 run because Garrigan really never got back into it after that. Lake Mills had an 18-15 scoring advantage in the third quarter to go up 56-35, then Bishop Garrigan actually had a one-point advantage, 15-14 in the fourth to close this one out. So 70-50 the final score in this one. Lake Mills with their conference record, 53rd straight top of Iowa West win, and kind of making a statement tonight. It's our conference until someone knocks us off, and thus far, no team's been able to knock off Lake Mills for several seasons.
Yeah, they are tough. They got something good going over there. That basketball team is dynamite. They do so well working together. They make great cuts to the basket. They have ball handlers year in, year out, and they always have a few guys on their team that can always get a bucket when you need it. And the Bears, you know, just right behind last year, like you said, they just behind Lake Mills in the scoring statistic. They're just behind Lake Mills in the rebounding statistic, right, in the conference last year. Overall
Garrigan
stats.
Was one ahead of Lake Mills in that
Garrigan
one.
Garrigan's
yeah.
one ahead of Lake Mills. So, you know, you've got some statistical categories that are really close, but Lake Mills has that. It's just that je ne sais quoi that Garrigan doesn't have, and Garrigan just can't quite sneak a game away from these Bulldogs. But, you know, like you said during the broadcast, Tyler, the timing of this game really, I think, has a lot to do with it. Lake Mills coming in polished. Bears clearly aren't yet. Bears just are, you know, they're figuring it out. Like we've said, coming off the football season, they're in the gym. They're just getting their basketball legs under them. You know, it'd be fun if these teams could play each other again later this season. But
which they will.
Which they yes. will. So that's a great test for Garrigan this season. They lost by 20 today. When they play Lake Mills again, will they be able to improve upon the effort that they had tonight? And I think part of that is going to be because, like, their lineup's going to be different. Right now, Garrigan has 10 guys that are all vying for court time. And they all look so similar right now. It's got to be really difficult for the coaches to figure out, all right, who are going to be our guys that we're going to start working on here to find those roles. Who's going to be this role? Who's going to run this offensive set? Because right now it almost seems like a basketball tryout right now for the Garrigan Bears as they try to figure out who's going to do what.
Yeah, a lot of the preseason time you'd be spending figuring things out is really being figured out right now on the fly for
yes.
Richard Garrigan as they try numerous lineup combinations, as you said, a lot of different strategies offensively and defensively they're trying to implement on the fly during this season.
Yeah.
So, and it's a tough early schedule
it
to
is.
Try to do that with Western Christian in the last game and Lake
yeah.
Mills in this one.
Yeah, just really tough beginning season competition for the Bears. And then you also have the dynamic that all these young men, they want to be one of those top 7-8 players that gets most of the minutes. So they're all maybe trying almost a little too hard to impress everybody and trying to get a bucket when maybe they should pass, or you know, maybe drive in the lane when maybe they should just run some offense. So there's just so many things that aren't falling in place for the Bears right now, but it's certainly not because of lack of talent, lack of effort, and lack of focus. You know, like they're going to figure it out as the season goes on. But there's going to be some growing pains here early on, especially against the tough competition like Lake Mills.
Meanwhile, no growing pains for Lake Mills. I don't think Lake Mills ever hit their top gear tonight, but I do think they got pretty close to it, especially for this early in the season. Looking at the scoring for Lake Mills, Aiden Stensrud had 19 points, Eli Menke had 17, Lance Helming of 16, and Nash Delger had an impressive 8 points off the bench, really all that coming at the end of the first half. On the Golden Bears scoring side of things, Michael Joyce had 20, and Carter Schwab had 12 as the two leading scorers. But like I said, BD, Lake Mills really did a great job tonight. Their strategy was clearly attack the interior, use just great athleticism. I mean, Helming's spin move is lethal. Stendrud has great touch underneath the basket and great power as well. So Lake Mills really wanted to attack inside, hit the occasional three-pointer, which they did, but they got a ton of paint points tonight, really sticking to that strategy.
They did, and then when Garrigan locked down the paint and tried to put the emphasis, then Dellinger comes in when there was a six-point advantage for them and turns into a 14-point advantage. So they took away the inside, and Dellinger hits those three-pointers, and that's what Lake Mills does. They have so many weapons, and they're very good at taking what you're going to give them.
Yeah, Bishop Garrigan was up 26-20 with a couple minutes to go until halftime, and then Nash Delger hit back-to-back three-pointers. Lake Mills went on a 12-0 scoring run, and Bishop Garrigan really never saw the light of day again after that, as Lake Mills led by about 20 for most of the rest of the game once they went on that 12-0 scoring run to end the first half. But for the Golden Bears, good news is they have a quick turnaround and two games this week to play as they face Newell Fond on Thursday night and improved Eagle Grove team on Friday night. So a couple interesting matchups coming up for Bishop Garrigan, both on the boys and girls side, and Beanie certainly trip to Newell Fond, that always gets the goosebumps going for everyone.
Yeah, boy, that's already on Thursday. Talk about more tough competition right off the bat. Of course, the girls game, a rematch of the state championship last year, and the boys Newell Fonda team has been fast and furious the last few times out. That's going to be a good one. So, and what a crowd. You know, this Lake Mills Bulldogs crowd is great. They bring a lot of people. That's a long drive to Lake Mills on a Tuesday night. They had a great crowd here tonight, a real passionate fan base. And I say this with the utmost respect for the Lake Mills Bulldogs, nothing as intense as the Newell Fonda fan base.
Yeah, that crowd in Newell Fonda is going to be loud, and they're going to be right on top of the players, especially that student section. It feels like they're breathing right down your neck when you're inbounding that basketball. So Garrigan will do for a hostile environment on Thursday night, as we will have coverage of that game on Home Country KLGZ. We'll have the Cyclone versus Hawkeye basketball coverage on Hometown Radio KLGA. But of course, the basketball video streaming will be right here on our Algona Radio YouTube channel. That will do it for tonight, though. For my partner, Beanie Bodie, I'm Tyler Lance signing off. This has been a sports production of Hometown Radio KLGA. Once again, final score, Lake Mills 70 and Bishop Garrigan.